What's up, right. Nick?
Come on in, Nick.
Nick.
That's all right. How you doing
there? When I'm eating right, I got to share with my girl. Like, I used to get so happy when I have a good shit. When you eat at this place, your shits
I'm
are shaped
having...
exactly like your fucking intestines.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
It fills up all the nooks and crannies.
It's just it's a fucking...
I don't even want to tell Nick what we're talking
NPR?
About.
Yeah.
I don't even want to tell you what we're talking about. This is the worst conversation to have as Nick walks into the studio. You know that.
But Nick eats well. Nick is 52, man.
Not like this shit.
52.
Nick is a fucking middle-aged man. He's older than everybody in this room, and look how good he looks.
52, yeah. I'm 48.
Come on.
That's fucking just the same, nigga. Your prostate's the same swell.
Oh, it is. Yeah, that's true.
Nick doesn't eat bad. He doesn't eat poorly.
Yeah, but he doesn't eat this shit.
I bet he does.
I have the prostate of Hyman Roth.
We're talking about the raw food.
I'd like to try that, but it just don't fill me up.
We just looked at the menu. We don't even know what to order.
Oh, you're ordering raw food for breakfast?
No, we're just trying to figure it out.
What Patrice's diet is now, and he's gone to this thing called raw. It bypasses anything vegan or any of that silly shit I've ever heard in my life. They have like a lasagna, but it's made with fucking squash or zucchini.
But raw, and not cooked?
The cheese is made, because it's not lasagna. The cheese is made of some kind of fucking nuts that are ground up and dried in a fucking dehydrator. The sauce is tomatoes, just blend it up, and then they bring it to you cold.
And call lasagna. Yes, thank you.
So, you don't have diabetes no more?
If I ate like that all the time, I wouldn't.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Right? You ain't going to do that. You don't block people with that kind of discipline.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean black comedians. I didn't mean in general.
Right.
I mean black headliners from the Northeast. I mean, you know what I mean.
Shit.
That's good. We don't want him dropping dead.
It doesn't sound good, though.
Patrice?
I mean, you could fucking live in a hyperbolic chamber, too, but... Yeah, what fine is that? I mean,
it's fucking possible to live like that if you could. You could be healthy if you mm-hmm. like you said, you gotta cook. And look, eating healthy is great when somebody's there to make sure you eat healthy, man. It's
right.
just
I gotta cook, and I just tell her to cook healthy and
do
tasty.
You have a cook?
Yes, some is the old. I'm cooking.
You have a cook?
Every time
runs
this
around with a rag on her head, a do-rag.
Every time this comes up, I got the idea from Anthony. Living in New York, guess what? It's about the same as fucking going out and eating and doing the takeout.
He hired Mr. Turkle from The Shining.
I know that sounds crazy when you say you got it.
We got legs of lamb.
Mr. Halloran. Turkle with the cuckoo's nest.
Halloran,
I was going to say, I was thinking.
Ain't got to cook a few years ago, and I said, you know what? Yeah. And I looked into it, and it's right. beyond reasonable.
But,
I'm telling
you know,
Patrice you should get
I'm a
one.
Single guy.
Yeah.
You know, you've got a wife.
Yeah.
Is it 30?
Yeah.
40? I taught myself to cook. Worst thing I did.
You cook yourself?
Yeah, I love to cook.
I heard you could cook.
I can.
Do you like
and
it?
I love to cook, but that's no way to keep weight off. What are we doing? Fucking, what are we doing? Martha Stewart?
I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, we should take this show down the hall.
We just asked Patrice what he's up to, and we're learning.
Yeah, well, I don't
good.
Know.
Did you try the Louis XIII? Completely changing subjects out of your girl's asshole, like you said you were going
to
do?
No, I'm saving for something.
See,
talking to me like Christine. I was wiping the bottle off. I got so scared to drop it.
You polished it up nice?
I put it in a safe. I was nervous. Because I'm like, Jesus.
Did you get all my greasy fingerprints off it?
Oh, you just.
Because I handled it a lot.
You could see all the times he was thinking about just fucking cracking it.
Like the around the neck, there's fingerprints
and
on the
shitty
cap.
Box. He had duct tape on the box.
Just so Nick knows.
What the fuck are we talking about here?
I had this bottle of Louis XIII that a comedy club gave me and Ann about 10, 11 years ago for doing the right thing. Yeah, I know. Isn't that sound crazy?
Sure wasn't the improv.
And I didn't know what the fuck I wanted to do with it. And Patrice was in here. He goes, fuck that. I'd be interested in that. So I just gave it to him.
Did you really?
Yeah, and it goes for like $110, $120 a shot at some of these restaurants and bars.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And like he said, he could see my fingerprints on it every time I was thinking of
you
opening
what's
that
he going
to
do with it? You can't drink that shit.
No, but I'm...
But it's a good thing
you know,
for...
get together this, though.
Do you?
Crack it.
P. Diddy.
He'll look like, yeah, that'll look pimp if he comes out and fucking pours that
shit. But I don't want to pour it for anybody that doesn't appreciate it.
You know what
they're
going to do with it? Will Sylvence drops the bottle.
Yeah. You know what they're going to do with it? They're going to mix it with Mountain Dew. And sure <you go>.
Just fucking
Robitussin.
Shut up, fucker. You got the same shitty friends, nigga.
I know.
Me and Nick got to page each other. Who's having a cookout inside?
They don't fuck each other's cookout.
Yeah. Cook same up. Fucking 40-year-old nothing. They come to each other. But it's
40 or nothing. I did what? Have you been to two of them?
I'm in two.
He comes to one, and then...
Will you just not do that? I'm telling you.
Why?
I know he's going to fucking say.
Go ahead, let's go.
He shows
he's
up
mad
the...
at me. I know, fuck you. Shows up. I'm not going to let him do it.
Let's go.
I'm not
going
to let you do it.
Let's go.
What's the big deal?
I did it as... Because everybody thought I was a douche for doing it.
No, to be healthy, you did it.
I did it as
a side. Let's go.
It was a side. That's all I'm going to say.
Go ahead, Nick.
I have a cookout, and then the following year I invite him back again. He shows up like $400 worth of Chinese food. What does that say about my cooking?
See, I knew it. It was like I was trying to be inventive instead of potato salad.
I believe you.
I brought rice and some little stuff. The hot dogs.
He had literally, it was like half the Golden Palace fucking kitchen.
I didn't think it was an insult until somebody just was like, why'd you do that?
So everyone wanted the Chinese food over the barbecue, probably.
No,
Did you eat any of the barbecue?
Yes!
Oh, okay.
Then
he yells at me because I didn't have any steaks, so I had to go and get him steaks.
Let me tell you something.
This has been
festering. I didn't have the kind of money you do. You saw the house.
Nick's house. Nick, here's what we should do. We should combine Nick's house
language.
Nick's house and my attitude is the greatest fucking good time.
Really?
He lives in the fucking... He lives in the...
But Nick's house and you combined with your purchasing, it drops property value.
Nick lives in the fucking Godfather 2 compound.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah. That's nice.
It's like beautiful.
Yeah,
beautiful.
We've heard
house.
About this house for a while.
It's a stone house, but I have that window that overlooks a pond.
Only thing is the wolves and bats. I got an issue. I got an issue with the animal. You can't have a dog. I got dogs.
So my wife's out there at work, and I stand in that window like this, and I imagine a gunshot and her following me going like in that bow window.
When my children play with their toys.
Yeah. Well, I never seen Opie's crib, but I would say the two best, well, the three best comedy abodes I've been to.
Mm-hmm. Top three.
Top three.
Go
in,
with three
in
first.
Order.
So...
Nick's house
is the best
house.
Nick's house. No, Nick's third.
Third, okay.
Oh, motherfucker. Why even bring up the list? Well, I knew I wasn't competing with this kind
of
money.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not going to lie, but Nick, comics.
How about my property?
That's what I'm saying.
It's the property.
How much property you got? Yeah.
That's what the makes.
How much does he got?
Well, no, it's not property? A lot of property, but it's nestled at the end of a private road in the woods.
Nice.
You got a pond,
and it's got like a pond the size of an NHL rink on it with fish.
That's nice.
Brick home. It's a beautiful.
That's what I want.
Everything.
Not brick, stone.
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 Beautiful.
Yeah, brick. Brick.
It's not brick.
It's only an hour and 10 minute ride to the Comedy Cellar every night.
But it's worth it.
You wonder why. Life's fucking short.
I would say Vinny is next.
Vinny has a nice house.
Yeah. Vinny has
Brand?
Fucking nice
God,
house.
God, motherfucker.
I saw it many years
and
ago.
And I think he has like 5 or 6 acres.
Favorito?
Probably fucking Vegas fucker.
What does he got? He's got 5 or 6 acres.
He might have 5 or 6 acres.
Oh, Vinny Brand?
Vinny Brand.
Is that old money too, or all the money he
No, made? It's white trash stress factory money.
Yeah.
Vinny has no old money.
Yeah, Vinny started with nothing.
A lot of kids, right, Jimmy?
Yeah, he's got a bunch of kids.
Yeah, a filthy cracker just like 7 years ago.
What makes
like
this house nicer than Nick's?
Nick's property, like I said, but Vinny's house is probably twice the size.
Well, he's twice as rich as me, too.
He's owned a club for 20 years.
Vinny's richer than you, Nick.
I'm not.
Vinny's a lot of money.
Do you see the shitholes I'm playing on the weekend?
No justice
except
in this
for
world.
This weekend.
Nice plug. Yeah.
Really.
I'm making an exception. No, I didn't mean this weekend. I meant a couple weekends
ago.
Gig.
Comics are a really good gig, actually.
Yeah,
Jimmy
did.
Are you doing Foxwoods?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I'm shooting a DVD on Saturday up
there. Oh, nice. Great place.
And you should go back.
That's why I'm here to plug it, by
the way. I'm going to calm down
I'm the worst marketer ever.
And had a rough weekend, so he's not going to join you, Nick.
I don't like taking a hit and then going right back.
What did you
gotta
do?
Got to let it settle in. Go blackjack, on. Yeah.
Play with your guns? No?
Not blackjack. Went there and
Where'd you
Jimmy.
Go?
Foxwoods.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Went up there.
I'm heading up there this weekend. Did I mention that?
Good club.
It's actually great.
Tonight through Saturday.
This is Patrice started the Foxwoods thing. He was the first.
Well, they called me, but I was booked.
And then Jimmy and then Nick. First 3 weekends at the Foxwoods Club.
Don't take that order and fucking.
All right, what? Tell me what's great about Vinny's house now. It's a lot bigger.
He built it himself.
What?
And it's
yeah.
Does that?
It's
look. What do you mean he built it himself?
He built it himself.
He picked up a hammer.
Yeah,
he's built. Well, his peak
angle.
He built it. He bought the property and put his house on the property.
Did he really?
Wow.
Yeah.
And he has a guest room that has like you know, one of those things in the mall. That you see that lead to the other his guest house. He has like a
bridge like a bridgeway
to the guest house.
Yet there's no green room at the comedy club.
He has a bridge in his house.
It's a nice house.
Like a walkway.
Somebody committed suicide.
It's a tremendous house, and I would say Anthony's is probably the best.
Because oh,
Anthony's is made. It's really nice outside. It's the nicest house I've seen outside. But inside, it's made up like, a dude. It's a dude's house.
It's
like,
a men's cave?
Yeah, it's a dude's house, but it's very nice. It's not a douchey.
It's a mafia house.
The only thing I can find walking around Anthony's house, judging houses.
I didn't know Patrice was judging everyone's houses.
You have to. Yeah. Nick's house, Nick tries to be so white. He has some kind of shitty stove that they used to that Grizzly Adams had, and it bugs
the wood burning
stove.
Wood burning stove.
It's the best.
I love wood burning stove.
But that's the thing.
I grew up with
and
one.
I have a real fireplace.
Look at you two, how you bound it.
We weren't allowed to have heat in our house, basically. So we had a fucking roll of newspapers.
It's different for him. He does it for white reasons. Nick does it for.
I was there when I bought it.
Some kind of Republican. That's why he bought the fucking house.
I bought it from a white guy. What do you want me to tell you?
To remind him of happier times.
Yeah, he's just throwing nigga on the fire.
You're not going to a store and getting a wood burning stove.
I don't like that type of thought.
How much does that wood burning stove weigh? You're not going to a store and getting that shit.
You're going to the store and get anything if you got money.
Dude, no way.
I have the manliest room. That room with, the coat of arms standing in the corner.
Oh, shit. You got one of those?
The doorknobs are cock handles.
Cockheads. Cockhandles.
Cockhandles.
What a faggot.
I got what you meant. But
that room, you got to admit.
Have you been to Nick's house?
You got Nick's
house.
You out-guineed me. You may have out-guineed me.
It's not a real one. No. But that room is the it's got the post and beam construction with a cathedral ceiling.
Oh, that's nice.
And it's that's the room that got the.
Why haven't we been invited?
Because you'd never come on the weekend.
I would go.
Excuse me, Norton. I've asked you twice, and you were busy.
No, I never got invited. Never.
The first cookout I had, you were one of the first people I called, and I didn't hear back from you. Then the second year, you were busy. You were booked somewhere. And this year, I didn't call you. No, because I looked at your schedule or something. You weren't around.
I would go, Nick. I'll check out.
But I did. But it's a beautiful place.
Yeah.
The land is. It's a
I call
beautiful.
I five people I like in the world.
It's a peaceful place right off the side of the.
Come up for football.
The Tekakit. What is that?
Taconic.
Taconic.
It's way up there.
It's a beautiful place, man. It is. I can't lie. It's beautiful.
It's gotta be. You gotta.
Vinny's is beautiful.
You gotta move away from the city to get anything halfway decent.
To get land.
You wouldn't believe what I'm. I pay the Westchester has the highest property tax in the nation.
Yeah, I'm second. I came in second.
My town has the highest in Westchester.
Oh,
my
shit.
Side of town has the highest in the town.
Really?
My town has been mentioned in the New York Times.
Yeah,
I'm at ground zero for the property tax war in this country.
What's your yearly?
I can't even. I'm not gonna.
It's so put it this way: if you hit,
I'm being raped. It's when I read it, I'm like, what am I doing?
Let's say you do.
Unbelievable.
100 more smoking gun things.
He had such a subtle way of ruining him, busting my balls. Isn't he something? The fucking meanness in this guy.
What does that mean? Smoking gun thing. I know I missed
on TV. He does the smoking gun thing.
Oh, okay.
Now Nick's got to get laughed at twice. Oh, shit. What an asshole. Because Jimmy's stupid, Nick gets laughed at
twice. I didn't know what it was.
No, that's his way of busting my balls.
I'm saying, Nick, if you paid off all the principal.
That's a salary for me, by the way, that show.
If you play,
you're gonna tell me Tonya Harding ain't funny.
If you paid your house off, would the taxes still be like despicable? Like you still have to work hard just to pay the taxes?
Not work,
on the house?
Not work hard.
But still, it's
here's my taxes. Big bill. Here's my taxes every year.
Yeah, that's more than me.
What? That's more than you?
Do that with your hand again?
No, I'm not going to do this again.
No, no, no. But the first one.
And, yeah. and how many zeros was that?
No.
That was just, four. You meant to say four just, zero.
Yeah. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digit number.
No.
And it's
so is mine.
Wait, yes.
So yeah, is mine. Yeah.
Wait, can you just?
That ain't bad at all, though.
That ain't bad.
What? Not for fucking his house, man.
Yeah, it is.
When I'm paying fucking school taxes, we're talking and this, I don't right? have kids.
I'm paying.
Yeah. Let me.
I'll give you an idea.
More money in school tax than property tax.
How much I'm paying more? My school taxes to Austining.
Yeah.
Because of something that was seriously
yeah, it's
to,
great.
To and I don't have kids.
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't live in
Austin. Are you at that number?
A little under that.
That's where
a little under that.
That's where okay. I am.
That's crazy.
It is crazy.
It's a lot of money
to own property. You're paying taxes,
and then to have some fucking asshole tell me. You're not doing your part. You're not patriotic. You gotta help more.
Yeah, exactly.
Pay more taxes. Like, go fuck your mother. I'm paying that, and that's just property tax. Now it's income tax and everything else. Fuck
it's
you.
It's unbelievable.
Pay more. Exactly. You elitist. Shut up.
That's why
how about you
how
go to
I
work
am.
And pay.
Thank you.
Fuckers.
That's where it comes from.
And I went.
But you have to make that fucking.
Now I
that
vote
shit.
In every city and county. Fucking. You should see me. I'm like an old man.
I am right in that school.
I'm watching
online.
Local. I'm watching newspaper. Local access. I can put a tree in my yard, but it's gonna cut. Well, they're not free
I'm
anymore.
Pulling banners out of people's lawns.
No. We have that discussion.
Fucking
all
Democrat
the time.
Cocksucker! I'm running over people's lawns,
knocking over mailboxes. That's a man act. I give little kids a finger. I know who my taxes go to. I say, stand at a bus stop. I go like,
fuck you.
They don't even know why.
Yeah, you
know,
let me apologize.
And they get
I'm working the math out of my head.
They get pissed
I
when I fuck them.
That is a lot of money.
Yeah, and that's for that kind of money, you should be able to molest them.
Exactly. Free of charge.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Sacrifice one.
And that's on top of a mortgage. That's not even.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah. Like, Bill
comes out with a bleeding, exactly. bleeding hiney. I just show my tax bill and they go, you're free to go.
Is your taxes in your mortgage too?
No.
Oh, they don't do that?
Oh, no.
They do that for you or no?
No, because I had a jumbo loan. I put so much up front. And
yeah,
it's unbelievable.
That's, yeah, mine's a separate the taxes in
yeah, the mortgage and the tax and it's ridiculous.
It's just to have a roof over you.
Just to
it's
live.
Really stupid.
And of course, look, I know I'm not living in a hovel, but but the truth of the matter is, it's like,
you have a movie theater in your house. You have the best house I've ever seen. It's amazing.
How many more years is
I know I want to see that joint.
It's an amazing house.
I can imagine. No, I can pay it off pretty quick.
No, I'm saying is it?
That's why I wanted to get into radio.
30. I got a 30, but I dump a lot of extra cash into it.
Yeah. To buy it?
Yeah, because you know what? And I've heard from my accountants and shit that, like, you know, you should probably not pay in
oh,
so much
them.
On the principal.
Pay into it.
Because I'm thinking like this. I'm like, fuck that.
I
want to
get rid of it.
I'm going to be shitting my pants anyway. It's like, it's my house.
Then you just got
it's not my house, so it's
family,
fucking mine.
It's vulturous family members waiting for you to die so they could take it.
No, but it's like you're paying interest to the... I have almost 90% paid off because I put everything in a principal, so I didn't lose it when the stock market fucking shit the bed. And it's like, what am I going to do? Fucking give interest to the bank? Those scumbags?
But
I pay off, so I don't have to pay them interest.
My accountant is of the mindset that I could take the extra principal and actually make more interest than I'm paying
they
on
all,
the interest.
All accountants say that. Well, you know, you're going to get extra amount of points on your money. But how many points on my money am I going to get that's going to first compensate for the interest I'm paying? Mm-hmm. So you have to get money on top of the interest you're paying
right.
you have to make. So
you're,
it's
almost
like,
done, you're almost 90% done?
Yes. But
so,
I paid a
so
lot of
are
money
you get,
into
wait,
principal.
Are you getting, you must be getting letters from the bank saying, Mr. Norton.
Slow
you,
down.
Yeah, please slow down. We need you, sir.
No, I think they want the money. Anything you can pay them, they want.
You guys should have the house as your
house. They don't want you.
I shouldn't be living in the one. See what I'm saying? You guys, come on. You got a hit radio show. I'm fucking scraping by here. And living
yeah, exactly.
Well,
Jimmy, they don't want your money. They want you.
Yeah, they want you to.
I
they don't want you to
dump
pay.
Money into principal.
Yeah,
I've been doing it for 5 years.
That can't make them happy. That doesn't make them happy.
I hate paying them interest like that. It fucking sickens me. What, and how much are you going to invest to make
the
money?
That's why they lend money. It's like, why would they lend you money if they think you're going to pay it off?
No, I know. But it's just, you wind up like paying double your fucking place if you go 30 years.
And you know who runs it? The Polish.
Oh, of course. We all know that.
Absolutely.
No, it's not the Polish.
Literal Jim.
Oh, man.
I love paying principle.
I like how we go from shit to high finance.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's the same topic.
That's why the show should be a huge fucking hit.
It should be. It's just whatever the fuck happens.
But really, how much do we teach people? Ah, fuck them. Don't do that. That's stupid. All right, we're going to take a break. I eat really healthy. Well, tell us about raw foods. Ah, your shit looks like your intestines.
We'll be back
on refinancing.
SiriusXM, the virus. This is the Opie and Anthony Show. Opie and Anthony Show.
Got a busy show today. Patrice O'Neill in studio. Big Mama Prods on Twitter. I get a lot of my info from Big Mama Prods.
I do too. Oh! I really do. It's like the news.
Speaking of which, Patrice, really fast, you're going to be at Bananas Comedy Club, Hasbrook Heights this weekend, right?
Yes, sir.
Friday, are you really?
Friday and Saturday, wow. Two shows each. But before I move on to Nick, weren't you talking about the NFL on your Twitter? Because I brought it to the show and I look like a complete asshole. Aren't they starting to fine for legal hard hits?
Yeah, football's
not. Yeah, illegal. They're going to ruin it. They're going to ruin it.
Legal hard. The dude from Pittsburgh.
People thought
is
I was crazy.
No, you're right, Patrice. They're going to ruin it.
It's over.
It's the reason we watch it, to hope somebody gets.
And you know Mark Sheriff, a sheriff. I don't know, but he said something so hilarious. He goes, NFL has tapes called hardest hits ever.
Right.
And then they do the top 10 hardest hitters ever.
Right. Right.
It's not. And then somebody else said something that Mike Ditka and some other old coach said, take the helmets off.
Yeah,
and
well,
them motherfuckers will stop fucking hitting like
Paterno. Paterno said, take the face mask off.
Right.
He said, leave the helmet, but take the face mask off.
Just go with the leather helmets.
Yeah,
meet in between.
The old fucking, yeah.
Meet in between with the leather helmets.
And you'll figure out, because you know what? You watch rugby.
That's brilliant.
It's football without.
Oh, yeah.
No, it ain't. Now, I'll tell you why. I hate that comparison.
Dude, they are hitting.
Rugby's a brutal sport.
First of all, it's not.
It's not.
First of all, you.
All right, good.
Can I finish? You cocksuckers. the proof
nah,
that you can
but
play.
If you got it.
You asshole.
How many black 6'6", 380-pound black guys that run a 4.5 4 did you see playing rugby? Try tackling one of those motherfuckers.
All right,
wait a second,
go.
Though.
He just killed your argument.
Not fucking English.
In fact, you have to wear equipment to play football.
Yeah.
I know they are.
And they're white.
And they arm tackle. And they arm tackle.
I used to say that they didn't tackle those fucking guys.
Nothing like football.
It's not explosion, because they'll kill each other.
No,
well, that's
you hit as hard as they can hit without equipment.
The fact that you don't wear equipment proves that it's not as rough. If you played football without equipment, you'd have three deaths every week.
What is that music?
I don't think so.
No. Tatum over the middle, you catch a pass.
Is someone getting a phone
What's
call?
What's going on?
That's Patrice.
Your fucking music.
Oh my god.
Hilarious.
It's some kind of music.
I know. It's a soundtrack from When We Were Kings every time he gets a phone call.
22-inch woofers in his phone.
So now they're going to fine guys for legal hits.
Yes.
That's crazy.
It's so funny. They go, you know, hitting, the rule is called hitting a defenseless receiver. Every time a guy catches a ball, he's defenseless.
Right.
And always will be.
Right.
That's when you unload on him. That's why we started watching football.
Yeah.
I was a strong safety in fucking high school, and that's why I played. Guys are defenseless. You fucking lay them out.
They interview Ray Suggs,
the other guy they interview a couple of the Ravens, and they go, I don't give a crap. What are they going to do? I'm still knocking mothers out. That was their interview.
I'm still going to knock guys out.
What?
That guy Harrison from Pittsburgh.
Mm-hmm.
He's putting motherfuckers out.
Out.
Yeah.
Out. Every game he's knocking a motherfucker out.
Last weekend was the most vicious weekend. There was like five incidents. What do you mean? Did you see the Atlanta game? Both guys were unconscious before they hit the ground. The guy who did the hit and the guy get hit.
It was vicious because for some reason, first of all, why are they doing this? Because it's never for the benefit of the fucking player. It's something.
Because lawsuits,
I see things.
Insurance.
It's something going on. Because
it's the advertising.
I seen some on HBO about the old players.
It's a feminized
and
world.
Their fucking knuckles is poking out of their wrists, and they fucker can't get up in the morning because Night Train Lane was fucking hitting them with his forearm. And that's what we wanted. We wanted you to destroy yourself.
That's what we want.
Well, you know what's happened though, Patrice.
Well, what do you think it is?
I'll tell you what it is.
Sorry.
Well, I'll tell you what's changed it.
Yeah,
I'm sure that's part of it, and that and the feminized culture that we fucking live in. So a few kids get paralyzed. Big fucking deal. Let's play the game.
But you lose one every once in a while.
No, exactly.
For our entertainment.
But what's happened is, you know, steroids were introduced into the game. Now you get guys 6'5", 3'10", running a 4'2", 40", and your joints weren't meant to take that. Some guy, seriously, that's why you're seeing injuries. And AstroTurf. When you get hit on AstroTurf, your foot doesn't give. That's why you have people blowing their knees out. their bodies, you weren't most...
So why don't they go back to grass?
Huh?
That would help.
Because, again... That's a money thing.
Yeah,
it's a lot cheaper for cheaper turf.
I always thought it was insane they played on turf.
But right? it makes for a better
hit.
It makes for a more vicious game. Like I like the mud and stuff, but I'd rather watch a game on AstroTurf.
I love muddy games. The mud games.
But the hitting is much more crisp on AstroTurf.
Yeah, it's a lot more solid. Yeah.
So why don't you just put a flag on everybody and they take the flag and then the man stops running?
Flag football. I wouldn't be surprised.
It really, that's where we're headed. Is getting,
bunch of bitches.
It's not. I guess to...
I hear what's going to happen.
I'm trying to figure out how, as a football player...
Yeah.
Because I remember, what's his name there? Kiwanuka or Yumi, one of the guys from the Giants.
One of the guys from England.
He made a play, right? He got to the quarterback and stopped. Remember that shit? He didn't hit the quarterback, and it was Vince Young, and he didn't. Vince Young was getting ready to throw it, but he didn't throw
it. He pulled up,
and he.
Would they just go like, "Oh, I know what you're gonna do. You know what I'm gonna do. Let's just stop it right here."
He didn't want to get a fucking penalty,
right?
So he didn't tackle the guy, and everybody's screaming at him. But I'm sitting there going,
"Oh yeah. I remember that."
Because that's what they're doing now. They're fucking penalized. There was one hit this week that I think was a little bit fucked up. Was the Patriots guy. That's it. The Patriots guy, because the dude had already fucking dropped the ball, but he was still in the air.
Yeah, Merriweather. Left his feet.
And he
left his feet.
He jumped up at the same height.
Yes, he did. He left his feet.
And what's his name? Who's the coach?
For who?
Patriots.
You know, Belichick.
Belichick goes, he looks at the guy and he's like, what the
rolled
fuck?
Rolled his eyes.
What's wrong with you?
He left his feet.
He was even like, what the, that's not football, you asshole. Like,
but it is.
That's what everyone wants to see. Yeah.
That's how I played.
Yeah, well,
I really did. Anybody that wasn't paying attention and the whistle hadn't blown, I'd get a 40-yard run and just fucking, I was as dirty as they come.
Oh, safeties can be the most vicious.
Jack Tatum was, I played what they call him, a monster back. I was strong safety / linebacker. My first priority was pass, but I lined up next to linebackers. It was the best position ever.
That was your best player would be that position, the Monday, we call it a Raider, which
that's
is
right.
A hybrid.
That's
a hybrid
linebacker / safety,
like a too little to be like a middle, but he had the attitude of a middle, and you could just hit on little baby receivers.
Yeah. Raising his hand over there.
Only thing that bothers me is please stop with the prayer hands.
Oh.
I don't want prayer circles, and nope. I don't want the visiting crowd to be quiet after you get fucked up.
You should be like.
I don't want no thumbs up.
Can I add one thing? How long is Breast Cancer Awareness Month? It's longer than Black History Month. Got to watch every guy fucking felon dressed in pink.
It's creepy to see him in pink.
Yeah, that's what that shit is. It's some women's movement once again sticking their fucking beak in. Can we put an emblem on the field? I'm not saying. Look, I'll send money.
Jesus Christ.
I'll send money to Breast Cancer Awareness. I'll donate money.
White people got 10 more months.
My goal is...
It's White History Year, give a nigga a month and give bad titties a month too.
Yeah, but the pink
is wrong with
the pink is what we have a problem with.
It's the pink.
My goalie could be wearing pink goalie pants.
No, exactly. And
it's hockey.
It's enough. All right. Put an emblem on the field. We get it. It's symbolism.
Yeah. Sure.
But Jesus Christ.
Pink everything
and
up.
And once again, because it's an all-male thing, it's the same reason they have broads on the sideline, just letting you know that they hire women. It's really a fucking horrible time to be white heterosexual, man.
Yeah, yep.
You
absolutely.
You don't like the broads on the sidelines either, right? I hate that shit.
Pussies.
Pam Oliver doesn't offer anything.
Thank
I don't
you.
Hate her, but she doesn't offer
I
anything.
I do.
I hate it because I know why she got the job.
Exactly.
Or these girls got the job because they look good on TV.
No, because their knowledge of a 3-4 defense.
Yeah, really sure.
Let's go to Susie Kolber, a little Jewish woman, and tell me how a 4-3 defense works. Yeah, what are we going to go to fucking Ray Lewis for daycare tips? What a backwards, upside down fucking world. PU with your fucking political correctness.
Language.
You fucking liberals are done, November. You're going to take it right in the ass.
But do you think it's women in terms of like football? Are they getting together to make football less violent? The only setup would be that they would make it less violent so they can play with men somehow.
Well, they have their own league now.
Well, yeah, it's great. Not the players, right?
Like the lingerie one is beautiful.
No, because Ray Lewis needs to be able to fuck you up.
Yeah, the players don't want less violence, obviously.
Quarterbacks can't be touched.
It's society as a whole, though. It's creeping in. PC is creeping in everywhere. There's what, you know what I mean?
You said creeping?
Creeping in.
Yeah, what's creeking?
Okay, it's not creeping. It's a full-blown...
I wish it was just creeping. Then we'd have a shot.
Yeah.
To push it back.
We only have ourselves to blame. Yeah. Fucking, you know what I mean? No fucking pink gloves. No fucking emblem.
By the way,
I don't think that hockey player should have got fucking...
Don't even get me started. The blowjob gesture?
No, the guy that roughed up the dude on the sideline for a second. Gave him the...
What did he
grab
fucking...
him, snatched him up, and they're going to suspend him probably about 10 games or so.
Wait, which
one was
the fan?
Yeah, the fucking guy grabbed the fan.
Yeah, I think he should be able to grab fans.
I do, too.
Who's the basketball player that ran into the fucking stands?
That was a whole nother fucking...
Oh my God.
I love that, too. Was somebody talking about his daughter? Yeah, yeah. Somebody was talking about somebody...
No.
That was on the... Trailblazers.
He got hit with a beer.
No. This was in the Trailblazers. One of the Portland Trailblazers railed it because somebody was talking about their daughter or some death thing that a fan was heckling them with, and they fucking ran up and attacked them.
You know what? 100% of the times when the fans are attacked, they deserve it.
No, absolutely.
I would say 100%.
Yeah, no one's ever gotten attacked just for going go
right.
team.
Because we've all been to sporting events. You see these guys.
The Artest thing, that was so funny because...
Amazing.
But he went after the wrong guy. A white guy just minding his business.
He fucked up a little.
And Artest is coming at him. This guy was like
hey!
He had this look of fright because there was a guy behind him that threw the cup of beer.
Yeah, he's like,
and Artest thought it was this little white guy. It was the funniest guy.
Yeah, the look on that guy's face, he was petrified.
Patrice, what's up?
Isn't football a gladiator?
Yes, it is.
A spectacle that those guys know that there's a risk and it's a life and death kind of...
Yes,
it's just like MMA. It's really a gladiator thing. It's entertainment.
Yes, it is.
Can we go back to the hockey thing, though?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know the incident, Patrice, with the hockey guy.
What do you mean?
With the fan. How did that happen?
He walked up. The guy was doing something.
It's tough to get to the fans in hockey.
He got kicked out the game and he was walking.
Through the breezeway.
And the dude was talking, leaning, you know, he was clapping and saying something to the guy.
Right.
And the fucker just snatched him up. And he let him go. He didn't hit him, but now even if Barry Melrose says it's bad, then it's like he's going
to
get suspended.
He has to say that.
He has to, right.
Meanwhile, he's laughing off
camera.
And that's
the thing about sportscasters now. They've become...
They're horrible.
Fucking pussies.
Like, yes, they have.
They're the worst.
Dan Dierdorf, who used to be like one of the dirtiest players for the Cardinals in the 70s. He was the most vicious, one of the most vicious players. Him and Conrad Doble, two dirtiest linemen in the history of the NFL. Now he's like, that was uncalled for, that face mask.
Was it?
They got to watch this stuff.
Yeah.
And now he's such bullshit.
People of Rome, Maximus Borrelius will be wearing a pink shield today for breast cancer. Awareness Month.
Are you not entertained?
As he takes on the horde.
Can't we just write a
with
check?
With fucking Nerf swords.
With Nerf swords.
It's something.
Ladies and gentlemen, Caesar's giving a thumbs down for that gladiator.
PC,
this isn't good.
Yeah,
this isn't good.
You can't hit. I'm going to tell you the most vicious hit I've ever seen. Kermit Washington.
Remember that punch?
Knocking out Tom Donovan.
That's right.
Holy shit.
They shattered like a plate. Like a China plate you dropped in a driveway.
Because they were both running at each other.
No.
That was the one where it was
Kermit Washington
was running toward him as well.
What a great place to drop a plate. You can't not break a plate in the driveway. It's impossible.
No saving it.
Yeah, I say that because I dropped a pizza stone once that somebody gave me like 10 minutes later for a gift.
What's a pizza stone?
You cook pizza on it. Put it in your oven and huts up. Heats up like a... Huts up? How
it
fucking...
Up.
Hello?
Oh.
Hello? It's a big flat rock to make better pizza?
Yes.
You should have dropped it. You should have thrown it at him. What kind of shit gift is this? Mushroom rock. Go fuck yourself.
Jimmy gets annoyed, though. I love
what
it.
What a horrible gift.
Rock.
What are you talking about? You can do your laundry on it down by the river?
Exactly. Great thing to bludgeon an old woman with her own pizza stone.
Greatest hit ever, Kermit Washington.
Sam Huff on Frank Gifford.
You got the wrong guy.
Is it, what's his name?
Chuck Bednarik.
It wasn't Bednarik?
Yes.
With a shoulder pad was the hardest hit I've ever seen.
Really? The pad made of pillows too.
It wasn't helmet to helmet. It was.
They used to
hit you nasty with your shoulder back then. It was really
dirty.
Oh.
Nice.
How about Sammy White going over the middle in the Vikings Raiders Super Bowl and Tatum laying him out? Remember his helmet
Jack
pop?
Tatum was.
He was the best ever. The guy should be in the Hall of Fame. He was my idol.
He was paralyzing motherfucker.
He was the baddest motherfucker ever.
You was gonna get paralyzed. You fucking around over
the middle.
He was
5'10". Listen to that. 5'10", 220 pounds. Ran a 4.440. That's like a little missile.
And he looked
and he was as vicious as... He grew up in the same project as George Foreman. George Foreman used to beat him up and take his lunch money.
Did he really?
Yeah, it was in
that's
the book.
That's your story?
They call me assassin? Yeah.
Oh, that's
George
funny.
Foreman used to beat him up and take his lunch money.
I guess he fucking
but
got pissed
this
off.
This guy
that, huh?
was a badass. That team...
Same George Foreman for all the...
No shit.
All the really star of all. His family should sue George Foreman.
Daryl Stingley's family is fucking making food on the George Foreman grill.
Fucking Stingley.
Can I get another panini?
Thank you, George Foreman, you motherfucker. I cannot walk now because of George Foreman.
Tatum just died. He was my favorite, and they had another guy, George Atkinson, who was the cornerback that played with him. He was number 43. He owns a liquor store in Oakland, give you an idea.
Oh, wow.
But he...
A set of balls.
He,
how often do you get robbed?
When the Raiders and Steelers played, do you remember Len Swan went out for a pass? He wasn't even in the play. He's just running a pattern. Tatum comes up from behind with a forearm. Knocks him out. Shit. He's not even in the play. Knocks him unconscious.
But the dude for the Pittsburgh Steelers was even worse.
Nobody was worse than the Raiders.
Mel Blunt.
He was a mean.
They started rules for Mel Blunt.
No, right. It was the Raiders.
Mel Blunt used to beat your fucking ass. That's he started the 5-yard rule.
He was a real bad.
But get back to the Len Swan thing.
He just laid him out. It was the second
play
of the game.
And he wasn't even in the play.
And then when the Patriots played the Raiders in the 70s in a playoff game, AFC Championship, first play of the game, George Atkinson runs up and punches Russ Francis in the nose and breaks his nose. For no reason at all. Just like a street fight. Whang! And they had it on replay. They showed it like 8 times. Russ Francis runs off. Big tight end nose all bloody.
No fucking suspensions back then. What was Pete Rozelle doing?
They went to court. They went to court because of the Len Swan hit. They actually went to court, and they put Chuck Noll on the stand, and they asked him, does your team have a criminal element? And this is the Steelers. They weren't as dirty as the Raiders. And he goes, yeah, we do have criminal element.
You admit there's a criminal element. Was the same guy.
He was a mother, too.
He was a piece of shit.
What fucking happened? What happened from then till now?
But it didn't.
Now they're wearing pink. You think Jack Tatum would have wore pink on the field?
It's only been fucking 20 would have been like, oh, fuck their titties. Come on, paralyze a nigga.
That was Patrice, by the way.
He's a lot to say.
I don't give a fuck about no titties.
The only pink you're going to see when it's... Oh, open somebody's head.
Got to take it so hard you wind up the next week or something.
Oh, stop it.
Fucking Chip.
Steelers, Raiders in the 70s, there was nothing better. Nothing better.
Who was the guy from San Francisco?
Which one? What year? I'll tell you.
Safety. It was
Ronnie Lott.
Ronnie Lott, who cut off his own finger. He had a busted finger, and they was like, you got to leave the game. He goes, nah. He cut it off.
Yeah.
He had it cut off and wrapped up so he could finish
the
game.
Shit.
Yeah. I'm telling you. But it didn't start getting bad.
Wait. You can't just casually say that. I don't know the story.
Well, it's a known story. He broke his pinky.
Yeah, because Jimmy's was priceless.
In some weird way.
On the field.
And they were like, we got to take it. He says, no, fuck that. Cut it off. He cut off his...
Why couldn't he play with a crooked...
like a knuckle?
I don't know. I think it was would have been infected.
It was a request by his wife.
He actually cut off the tip of his finger.
Yeah, during the game.
You know, Matt Mellon, we talk about the broadcast turning into pussies. Matt Mellon, he's the guy that was a GM for the Detroit for the last 10 years. He signed his letter of intent in blood when he went to Penn State.
Wow.
He gets recruited by Maryland, right? Goes down to Maryland to visit this, out of high school, to visit Maryland. him and the strength and conditioning coach have a bench lifting competition, and Matt Millen ends up beating him up in a fight. Beats up a coach that's recruiting him.
Which, by the way, is why fucking Jim Brown is the baddest motherfucker that
yeah,
ever
he's
played.
A badass. I hope he dies, though. Yeah.
Because Matt Millen...
racist piece of shit.
Jim Brown?
Racist, wife-beating piece of shit.
He's a racist.
He's a racist with his I hate white people hat.
Of course! Wait a minute!
It's for anybody that wears a kufi. What is this, Nigeria?
I would wear kente cloth drawers. Oh, please. He used to play where a white boy stomped on his nuts every time he got tackled and called him coon.
And your point is?
Take that, coon. Wouldn't you be racist?
No, but he was racist to him. He was a badass back then. You think any white person had the balls to... Come
God
on. He was a badass.
Holy shit. I didn't know Nick knew so much about football.
I was obsessed with it for years. Now I can't stand the NFL.
It's frustrating, right?
You guys, is it on? Can I say that?
Fuck it. It don't matter.
It's,
yeah. It started with the TO. You could feel it with the horse collar rule. Once they put the horse collar.
I agree, Patrice. Absolutely.
I go, something's wrong because the horse collar. My thing is, how are you supposed to
tackle a guy from behind?
6'5".
That's right.
225 all muscle. How the fuck are you without trying
piggyback
to take his knees out?
Yeah, you need
to fucking take his knees out and ride his back to get him down, unless you tag him.
How about this? Maybe they could have something hanging off the shirt that you could grab. Because a lot of guys did get hurt, you know, horse collar from behind. They could, like, leave it like a 6-inch rope so you could... You know what I mean? You could yank him.
Oh, Nelly.
Yeah. Oh, Nelly.
How about a long, hard stick you can hit his foot with? Why are we figuring this shit out? Because you're supposed to be able to jump on the back of this motherfucker's head.
Take him down,
that's
right?
But
I do understand how that rule came about, because I saw more guys getting fucking hurt in their knees and ankles, you know, getting tackled from behind. Fuck I understand, them. But I agree. It's a gladiator sport. It comes with it. When you come over the middle, you might get knocked out. That's part of football.
Yeah,
it's the reason people watch.
It's not arm tackling.
Can I say this, too? It's bullshit because it's fake legislation. It's not how people really feel. It's just like, hey,
that's
let's stop
everything.
This.
Yeah, that's the whole world.
That's the whole world.
It's like everybody's sitting there.
You said that about rape laws.
Everybody's sitting there fucking pretending like they don't want to see motherfuckers get hit. But if that was the case back in the days where the hits was brutal and you weren't getting up, people would go, oh, this has to stop.
Yeah, we got to stop that.
This has to stop.
Yeah, why didn't they?
No, but it's more brutal now than ever. The NFL, the guys are so much faster and bigger. Well, people are getting laid out. This past weekend, I couldn't believe what they were showing.
Yeah.
The Tampa Bay Atlanta game, this guy coming over the middle, this guy hit him, so he must have got a 30-yard run. They were both unconscious in midair. The guy that did the hitting and the guy that caught the ball, their arms were like, you know how their arms, Patrice, you know how they get this, ever see when a guy gets knocked out, their arms get locked up? Yeah. They're both... There's a picture in the paper. They're both
just
horizontal,
laid out
and their arms are already
mid-air.
In this position.
Wow.
Good.
And then the kid get paralyzed at Rutgers this week. I mean,
but that was a complete, mistake, though.
It
was
a kind of a freak accident. Yeah, but he's 275 pounds, a kid. He's on kickoff coverage team.
He's on kickoff.
Yeah.
That's how fast these guys are. You couldn't catch him.
Yeah.
You couldn't catch him.
He
tackled the guy, lowered his head, and he hit the runner. The guy with the ball just hit him wrong, and it just is horrible.
That stinks, that story.
It's
horrible.
Neck.
Football's in trouble, though, man, because these guys are getting too big and too strong.
They have to. Here's the thing. Somebody made a good point. I was on the way in here. They were talking about it on another show, but it's true. The guy's huge. And the field is still the same size. It's almost the argument they make in the NBA, how big the guys are. They haven't changed the size of the field. You know what I mean? If you gave them a little more room.
So they play in Canada, the Canadian, the giant
Maybe. I don't know, you know. But then again, that gives the guy who's doing the hitting more of a head start.
100 yards is a lot of room.
Exactly. If I get a good angle.
Yeah, you're going to really.
Harrison has a better angle. Than he had, just he fucking runs full speed.
Like fucking soccer field size that he can really...
And hits that little Maurice Jones-Drew.
This is when I knew Jack Tatum was a badass. Earl Campbell, who was my favorite running back of all time, he'd run over people, he could run around you. He was 235, by the way. Ran like a sub 4.440. He ran into Jack Tatum on the goal line, head on, I mean, head-on collision, helmet on helmet.
Oh, when he spins around?
He spins around, falls in the end zone. Earl Campbell doesn't get up. Tatum's just standing over him. I mean, he fell in the end zone, but Tatum just walks away. Earl Campbell's down for like 5 minutes, and this guy used to run over, you know, defensive players like they were little girls. When I, he never even put his arms out, Tatum. Just clang, helmet on helmet.
Helmet.
The guy must have a cement head, man.
What about Too Tall Jones? Guy that doesn't know football. What about that guy? Tall guy like that tall. Knocking around.
Hey, we got to get a plug in for Nick's shows at Foxwoods. You start tonight, right?
Yeah, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
This is going to be a strong show. Nick DiPaolo at Foxwoods Casino.
Can't wait. Haven't been up there.
Yeah, tonight, great tomorrow, club. And Saturday. There you go. How do they get tickets, Nick?
Tickets, you can go to comics, C-O-M-I-X, at foxwoods.com or 1-800-200-2882.
You remember that?
And yeah, I did.
Holy shit.
I've been doing a lot of press for this.
Yeah. So, it's a good gig, man. I did it last week. It's fucking
good room,
Jimmy?
It's a great
room. I was surprised how much I liked it. Yeah. Really good.
I'm gonna try to shoot a DVD Saturday night, so come on out, folks. Wanna pack the place. Nothing looks worse on a DVD than 11 people going, yeah.
Falling on the train tracks.
What happened?
What happened?
Some dummy falling on the train tracks.
Again?
But why are people running
to fall on
help?
The tracks?
Exactly.
Don't
help those people. How do you fall? You know why? Because you want to get on, you know, True TV.
That's it.
But a
I'll,
guy
be, I'll
ran
be commenting in... on that clip in a few weeks.
A guy didn't know.
Yeah, some guy jumped in to get him.
Why would you jump in?
Exactly.
Save yourself.
Look at the dummies trying. Can't even climb up the fucking side.
How close was this?
Yeah, it's one of those rails.
Oh, yeah, 750 volts.
Oh, that's good.
Look at this asshole kid. Get up, you fuck.
I love yelling at the television. It's nothing more fun than yelling at the TV.
It is so annoying because all of a sudden
I do it all the time.
That's why I wanted to get into radio so I could yell into
all the time, right?
Yes.
But it's annoying because all of a sudden now you have to save the fuck.
Now you don't.
Or you look like an asshole.
I don't understand that.
Right?
That's true because there's cameras everywhere.
Right.
That's right. Imagine,
there he is, just like, standing there, thanks. Not even helping.
Hey,
the guy.
Is that Anthony from Opie and Anthony standing with his arms crossed?
I wouldn't have fucking jumped down for my girlfriend.
Me either, Jimmy.
Baby, get up.
You'd make it look good with the shower.
Train
right?
coming in a few minutes. Get up.
Yeah. It's that third rail that I'm worried about.
Fuck yeah.
You're leaning
why
fucking
white,
clothes on money?
Why do white politicians always have to be seen with black children? Because I just want to know what is that deal?
It's called getting votes.
From who?
Black people.
Negro?
But they don't need the black vote.
Bloomberg.
They need the white vote.
Why is that lady
There's
fucking
more white people?
Why is she wearing her fucking bathrobe?
I've been asking
television.
That question, Anthony, for a long time, and I'm deemed as racist for asking it. I don't know.
I'm deemed as racist.
I don't deem you as racist for asking it.
By the terminology you use.
What are you talking about?
It like Anthony.
It's just every time you saw like Hillary Clinton reading a book, she's sitting there reading a book, and they show the kids, and it's just all black children.
Yes.
They never go to the white school and, you know, visit the little white kids and read to them.
Oh, no. She's very sincere when she spoke to black people. I don't hear long ways tired.
Oh, God. Oh,
remember
she
that?
Did that?
She tried to do that voice,
speech.
That accent.
Oh, shit.
I ain't been a long ways tired.
Can you imagine?
Sound like Alfalfa doing a fucking play.
Don't black kids deserve to be talked to?
Yeah.
Yes.
That is every time.
Yeah.
But not every time.
By their parole officers.
Oh, shit.
Who that, Jimmy? Don't say shit like. Come on, that was Bob Kelly who just called in with that comment.
Yeah, of
course. Did you get in trouble? I'm noticing that you're
Did you get in trouble?
You think he's toned down?
You think I've toned down?
Wow.
This is toned down, Nick? No. Nick is saying like this.
Am I not on serious Open Anthony show? What's going on? We're treating this like it's fucking AM 77.
Wait a second. Every time he'll say something, he goes,
I backpedal a little bit, you mean?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Did you get in some kind of trouble?
Not really. I mean,
something happened. I'm telling you.
All right, let's get into this.
Nick never said
what
happened. A little ass. Someone blogged about you. He got in trouble by
Let's go.
Someone's calling you, Patrice.
Oh,
shut that off, will you?
I'm gonna shut it off now, dude. I'm sorry.
It's good, I like you.
You calling Jimmy?
No,
I would. We were fucking with him.
This is what it sounds like at the Red Lobster on a Thursday night. Goddamn phones going off.
Yeah,
parking lot looks like an Escalade dealership.
Was that you who said that, Nick?
Did you that was Nick DiPaolo,
that was
yeah.
Nick DiPaolo?
Here's another one.
Hey, Patrice, when did we lose the Red Lobsters?
Oh, shit.
What year did that happen? Because I remember going to the Red Lobsters.
I remember being broke-ass white trash on Long Island.
We lost the Red Lobsters.
I still am.
I went once.
And by the way, I'm a big opponent of that shitty place.
Yeah.
We went there for, like, opponent. Okay, let's go to fucking, yes. Let's go to Red Lobster and fucking have something. It's a shit. Anybody happy about going to Red Lobster?
You're right.
It's a fucking asshole.
I went for the first time.
Fucking asshole.
On the road. I got a lobster tail. It was the size of my thumb. I go, it says Red Lobster and it should be Red Scorpion. This thing was like a half ounce. Fucking tiniest thing I ever seen.
You got to make sure the lobsters are big if you're at Red
Lobster.
Exactly.
I had crabs bigger than this in college.
And they're shrimp?
It's the
really
food.
It's the worst shrimp.
It's bad food. I'm sorry about it.
Wow,
I can't,
man. They were a sponsor.
In this corporate world,
I know.
Red Lobster, man. Man, it's embarrassing how people go. They jerk it. There's a Red Lobster on 42nd near my girl works over by there, and fucking that Red Lobster is a line
packed
around
right?
the corner.
People are just
every
stupid.
Mediocrity sells.
Oh, it really does.
Subway yeah. sandwich shops. Have you ever had a real submarine sandwich from an actual hero sub shop?
Why not go to a deli and get like a real one?
Sub. They don't weigh their meat at a real.
Subway sliced and shit.
They weigh it. It's like cocaine. Yeah. Ooh, 2.5 ounces. And it's shiny. You ever see the turkey? You could snort coke off it.
It's slimy looking.
Yeah,
it's
slimy.
It's sweating.
Yeah, there's a shine to it.
You go to a real deli, you have them cut the fucking shit right there in front of you, how thick or thin you want it, and put it on a real fucking roll or something. Not this bullshit.
We grew up in, you must, right? In Malden and Medford, there was a sub shop in every corner.
Yep.
You go in, they put 7 pounds of roast beef.
Yeah, now it's all corporate places.
Giant fucking meat.
Nobody with a Coke scale on the back going,
why the fuck won't corporate people decide to do good things?
I agree.
Why does corporate have to always be terrible? Why can't a corporate really guy does. Goes, put more, like, you know, a corporate company that's doing like this weird thing where they're trying to do
they're
better
giant Domino's.
Is Domino's.
Yeah, they're giant.
Like, show us your picture. Oh, shit, the cheese is stuck to the top of the box.
This is bullshit.
I fixed this motherfucking cheese. Like, Domino's is...
You know what, though? It worked, because I was amazed by that commercial. Show us your shitty Domino's pizza.
Yeah, that's pretty ballsy,
actually.
That was
pretty fucking ballsy.
What Mexican brought you this?
I sent them a picture, though. I got a pizza, and I let my dog poop in the middle of it. I opened the box. Look at this!
Exactly. Then they show a German and Japanese customer enjoying it.
Balls of commercial. I ordered the scat and pineapple.
But that's what do you watch Undercover Boss?
I want to. Every week I want to watch that show and I forget.
Of course you do. Another excuse to make fun of the white boss. That's all that is.
Have you seen it?
Yes, I have.
Not making fun of a white boss. What are you talking about?
Of course it is. You don't understand who runs television.
If you listen to Nick enough, you think this the plight of the white man. It ain't. Shut the fuck.
Hold on, Patrice.
The boss, right?
You're so naive about who runs Hollywood.
The boss goes out, and it's a simple show. It's not to make fun of the. It's to go out and see his company.
Yeah.
And see what the fuck they're doing at the company. They got some shitty motherfuckers that he goes,
I'm
going to fire you at the end of the show. And there's some people you feel bad for, but he ends at the end of the day, he's the boss. Sometimes the boss goes, this is interesting. I'm going to have to look into how fucked up my company is. And then in the show, it's not like the white boss.
It's not
making fun of the white boss.
No, let's hear Nick's side.
I can't. It's too fucking involved. You got to know who runs Hollywood, okay? They hate the corporate fucking world. It's ultra-liberal people. And the boss
Everybody hates the corporate world.
No, they don't.
You love the corporate world.
I don't hate the corporate world. I drove here today in a car made by a corporation. The tires are made by a big corporation. I like corporations.
What kind of fucking double horseshit?
See, you're buying it. They're brainwashing you.
Get the fuck out of here. I got to drive a fucking car. Do I like what they do at GM so my shitty car can work?
That's a corporation.
But you don't like the corporation.
They go after the power structure. The people that run Hollywood go after the power structure, which is white corporate guys. It's just another way of going.
Hollywood is a power structure.
I know, but it's not the same. Their politics are different, Patricia. Don't
really,
see
they
that?
Go after the corporate. When,
Jesus
when
Christ,
you fucking,
yes.
When you see a movie and somebody has a Coca-Cola and they go, oh, boy, am I fucking thirsty. Are you thirsty, Al Pacino? Like, it's just, it's fucking,
that part of
it's
it.
It's all corporate.
Oh, boy, all I'm going to have to fucking, all right.
All of
forget
it.
Forget it. You'll never understand.
Nobody will
you
fucking listen to the plight of the white man. No one.
It's
nobody.
Not the plight of the white man. It's,
a,
just...
it's corporate. It's a boss who owns his own shitty company who's working for it, and no one knows it's
the
him.
The point is that the guy in power is the bad guy, and the fucking...
He is!
And the guy, no, he's not, you fucking idiot.
Who's
he gave,
the bad guy?
He gave those idiots a job, didn't he? Anybody ever get a job from
his,
a poor person?
His minimum
anybody?
Wage? Here's what happens in that fucking thing.
Yeah, we'll let you run the company, Patrice.
The boss goes, oh, man.
I spilled coffee on my jeans. God damn it.
That means it's a good day for your neck.
Spilling it. Now, corporate, hot coffee.
Let me get this straight, because I've never seen the show. What
Starbucks
they do is,
just burned my lap.
The boss of a company.
Undercover.
Of a company. It plays the part of an employee.
Yeah, just to show he doesn't know what he's doing.
Different levels. Right.
And we're
company.
Supposed to laugh because the guy that owns...
Does he come
the,
off looking no, like he runs a company that doesn't even know
he doesn't
how
know
to
what he's doing. That's the message.
He doesn't need to. Look, slave owners didn't need to know how to pick cotton.
Oh, shit.
They just did it. He's a guy who started a company with his brain, mm-hmm. like the kid from Facebook.
They don't point that out, though, do they?
He doesn't know the fucking inner bullshit of the company. He just had an idea.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And he made money. But I'm saying this guy
really?
Needs to know how to make chicken. What
Patrice?
He does, wait a minute, what okay. he does is like he goes to fucking, they had one, the White Castle guy.
Okay.
And it was just, he would see the efficiency of his company.
So he was playing the part of what, a register guy
yes.
or a cook or something?
And he would have a lady, right, that goes, that get there like 5 minutes early, and she'd be talking to him and is like, I got to get in 5 minutes early because this other guy gets here 10 minutes early. I don't want to lose my fucking job. It's a, of course you have to manipulate it so it has human parts, but it's never the boss is just going woogity woog. It's him trying to do his job that he doesn't need to do.
Does he ever look bumbling?
Of course. And not every guy that owns a business, the head of it, had an idea. A lot of them started at the bottom and worked their way up like Dave Thomas and became the boss for a reason. 20-hour mm-hmm. workdays.
Where did Dave Thomas work his way up from?
What are you talking about? He started behind the counter at fast food places.
Don't people wonder why this new employee is being driven up in a limo and a fucking camera crew is following
him? Yeah, exactly.
That new guy is somebody.
Oh, yeah, what's the...
Did you watch it?
Yeah, how do they explain the camera crew? I think the desire to make fun of the boss is pretty...
Yes, it's just a power thing. I think that's something wrong, Patrick. I agree.
I wouldn't say race. I think everybody has that desire just to like most
I just don't see
too
many black bosses being made of fun on that show.
How do they explain exactly, Patrice? How do they explain?
And
the
I know what
crew?
You're gonna say. They don't have.
Oh, there's no. There's like they set them up. They probably call it like a
documentary,
like some kind of thing where it's like that, but it's the boss around. And then
man, how stupid are these
it's
people?
It's revealed. But look,
that's cameras the in their face. Their whole.
I'm sure
the
some
whole
of them
fucking
are hidden.
Show.
So it's a good fucking show,
shut.
Though.
Don't be fucking screaming at anybody. You don't know who they are.
It's a fun show to watch because look, yesterday. My phone was fucked up all day, and I'm calling AT&T, and I'm telling something's going on corporate-wise. The woman gets on the phone and goes, hello, my name is Jennifer. This is but will you please, and then do you live at the... But I go, miss, I don't want to interfere with whatever your training is, but you sound like a fucking automated
She's
computer.
Reading it, yeah.
She's
why
reading it. I always stop those people immediately.
Yeah,
go, let's,
like,
let's stop that.
I love my wife.
This is
shit.
The problem.
Yeah.
But it's but my point to even say that is they're teaching something in corporate. You can't be happy with how corporate thinks. It's impossible.
But there's
no
she's
way
she's got to be
think.
A little happy with the fact that she's working. You know?
Yeah, maybe, but her job is not safe because if they're teaching, the reason she's not fired, I mean, you go shopping all the time or whatever, like I said, there's only one teller now. You go on a Saturday, it's one teller and the rest is this automated thing. Once they can figure out
they don't
how to
want
completely
that's
eliminate
right.
the human element,
well, yeah.
you're fired.
Of course. They're well on their way to doing that
yeah.
as far as banks going. They don't, you know, they don't want, eventually
yeah, yeah.
there won't be banks. It'll all be done and then, you know, they can
at
rip
home.
You off easier that way. Seriously.
But that's what I'm saying. So when you see something that adds a little human touch, and I'm always giving these motherfuckers speeches. I'm like, why are you behaving like this? You cost your company money.
I make it money. So so ultimately, you're useless. If you're going to just, like, some of the arguments are just based on what the computer says. So once they can figure out how to, the computer to answer any fucking thing.
They use
do.
That as an excuse now. It's always when, you're right, when they call and they can't answer something.
Yeah.
It's like, well, we don't have that in our computer. They always blame the fucking technology.
Yeah. People are making themselves useless.
But they have to make money, corporations. The bottom line is the bottom line in a corporation. That's why when you get an argument, there's no logic involved. You're right. But that's why Subway sandwiches, they weigh their fucking meat.
But why? Because
they figured out the profit margin.
Right.
I understand.
That's what I'm saying. Right. That's the problem.
That's always going to be there with the business.
If you make $70 billion as a corporation,
I hear you.
You can't make 40? Like you can't.
Take it easy, Obama. No, you can't.
If you can make 70, make 70.
That's right.
And
you would be
because,
too.
Because you don't know if in 2 more years you're going to be making 10.
Grand, Patrice. You can make 140
so
this
it
year.
Is. You don't know in 2 years you could be making 10 or 5 billion.
That's right.
In a shithole, some other technology comes up, your piece of shit, and now you're supposed to be like, well, at least I gave some money away. And
no, not give it away, but you just, we're halfway decent. Not nickels.
But they would look at that. I agree with you. But they would look at that like it's not indecent to be computerized like that. They would look at it as it's efficient and better servicing the customer. Even though I agree with you, I hate them.
No,
but that's how they would look at it. Like,
right.
You know, we're trying to service the customer, so we read through this thing. Everybody gets the same service. Mm. They would look at it as we also have, as opposed to 20 years ago, 5 million customers. Where 20 years ago. We didn't have that.
Yeah, it was a lot easier.
There's
to
an immediate, there's an amazing demand for customer service too.
It'd be nice to have some humanity. That's
I agree.
Of course, it ain't.
I agree.
And no, it's going the other way.
It's completely going the other way.
There are some instances I love not dealing with people when shit works. Where like a credit card company, where there's like, oh, we have a problem. Yeah. You know, was there a charge done here? And you call up, you never have to talk to somebody.
Right.
You punch in numbers. Your last thing was this at such and such a place. This you push yes. Okay, thank you. Good. I didn't talk to one fucking idiot.
And a computer sounds so funny when it's asking about a website. It goes, sheet mail, strokers. LOL to yourself.
It was a Tuesday night.
Yes, that was my purchase.
When I say fucking corporate, too, I mean the things that they represent. I mean, the thing, like, you know, like the oil company represents, which is not to say I'm sorry. We apologize for destroying some of the planet. It's a bunch of he did it. We have to fire all these guys. It's just, sorry, man. Made a bad mistake.
Could you imagine?
Made a bad mistake, man.
Yeah.
A human.
But that's not enough to say sorry. On TV where they were saying we're cleaning up, we're doing everything we can.
What,
you know,
with the black lady that was like,
yeah.
That they always have to put an Aunt Jemima to make everybody feel better.
Yeah. I live down here.
Yeah, you Louisiana. And then the oil, and then have some Popeye's chicken too.
I was having some gumbo one night when all the stuff.
Fuck out of here.
I live down here and I work for BP and we ain't going nowhere.
Yeah,
white people going. We know that you're not going anywhere. Very obvious.
The commercials these days are really getting to the point of being unrealistic.
It's frightening. I've been preaching it since what? My first CD 15 years ago.
Yes.
There's one about Kodak camera.
Call what?
What?
I'll be the same angry white boy 15 years later.
That's right. Sorry, I'm ahead of the curve.
Nick started this shit.
Sorry,
I was been mad.
This started with Nick the
It was white presidents till fucking now, Nick. Who was you fucking pissed off about?
What are you talking about? White? What are we now, talking about
you
here
know,
now?
I'm just Obama, you call me Obama for some reason.
Well, you're upset that somebody can make $70 zillion.
Obama has become like a marketing thing where now every company is like, well, since we have a black president, let's get black people in every commercial.
Why not?
Why not? Because it's not representative.
It's only going to last 4 years.
But it's not representative of a lot of what's going on.
They showed a white man taking an order from a black man on a commercial.
I talk about it before. Any alarm company commercial. The bad white guy that's coming in the house, and it's the black guy at the substation.
Can we send some help?
And it's not only any white actor. They found the white. Apparently, Ed Begley Jr. is not getting his checks from St. Elsewhere, so now he's resorted to cat burgling. You know what?
How are you supposed to sell Vipers if Ed Begley Jr. is not fucking ripping off your car?
And the thing about that commercial is you could make it race neutral. You could put a ski mask on the fucking criminal. Nobody would know.
Yeah, you'd know, though.
You complain about that?
Give me your motherfucking money. You would know. Oh, it's him. And the eyes give it away.
I like the dumb guy.
And the grape soda in the hand. Sorry.
I like the dumb guy at the party. And they all leave, and he's like the cute guy, and he knocks on the back door, and she starts to come
boyfriend.
To the door,
yeah.
And he breaks the back window. It's like, she would have opened the fucking door for this guy.
Right.
She was all hot for him
and shit. There's a lot of white criminals.
Yes.
But they work for BP. They're not breaking in the front house door.
That's the advantage of the... It's this phony self-flagellation. Because it's fucking... It is people who are in charge poking fun at themselves, because it's like, if you poke fun at black people, these elitist white people are going, well, you can't because they really are the underclass. So let's poke fun at ourselves.
But
it's a phony self-flagellation.
No, I know Nick has seen this one and probably been as infuriated as me. The three...
Jungle Fever?
Oh, sorry. The three dumbest white people ever.
the three dumbest white people. Opie, Anthony, Jimmy.
Yes! Yay. Was he angry at the end of Roots?
No!
Why would he run, though? You got a job to do. All of a sudden, he's running away.
There's three dumb white people toiling over what aspirin to
Sandy
buy.
Sandy Duncan's thirsty and get her a drink.
They're sitting there going, this one, I got to take how many pills? I don't know. I got a headache. I can't do that. And this smartly dressed black woman with a well-cropped afro comes over right to where she goes. She goes, I need this. Advil. One pill all day and walks away. Yeah. And all the white people looking at her like, oh,
how did she do
brilliant.
That?
Of course they don't know. She was the maid.
Wait a minute. You can't have fucking dumb white
not
people that don't know.
That's
not
on
the point,
purpose.
Patrice.
It's done on purpose. It's done with a purpose, like, let's make sure the black woman smart one.
That is my point. The people who
as opposed
God
to what,
damn
though?
It.
As opposed to having a black woman and a white guy standing there going, I don't know what the fuck to buy, and a Chinese person coming over going, oh, I've
no,
been gold,
but you know what? But I think, let's be honest, this is why I'm going to let you guys have it after this.
Oh, shit.
It's impossible to argue race with white people for this reason. Mm-hmm. White people think racism is only niggas, dogs, hoses, lynching, and fucking slavery.
Racism.
If you can hide that, right? You think that
it doesn't
exist.
That's following you around in the stores.
That was a list of...
But I'm saying...
Anthony's 10 favorite things.
That's what I'm saying. So what I'm saying, Anthony, is this.
Yes, sir.
You see the other scenario you set up? How come it couldn't be a white guy, a black woman confused, and then a Chinese guy?
Yeah.
The part that I would have trouble getting the truth out of most white people is that they would have problems with the Chinese guy, too.
That's really? So much bullshit.
If it's not white, just
so
like when people say...
Depending on what the product
just like
was.
Just people say, why, if there's a BET, if there was a white... Every other channel is white entertainment. They just call it other letters.
You make up 14% of the population. If you watch TV and you're from
what
another...
Can I fuck you? No, first of all...
Let me finish.
You're Italian, Nick.
You keep saying that.
You fucking... But
so what?
It's just you.
I'm English too.
And fucking Louis C.K. He's Mexican. You're an immigrant. He's an immigrant. But you took white. You fucking took a color. Now if everybody else band together with a
color.
What
are you talking about? My mother's side is from England, so that doesn't
count.
She's
English.
That's
she's
fucking
not a
white.
Fucking
why
white
does my
person.
Italian override my whiteness?
Why is
you
your
dumb
English and your fucking Italian override? Why does your whiteness override your fucking nationality?
I know I check white on applications.
I'm a white European
things,
male. I'm called that.
You're a fucking Italian.
I'm a white European male. I'm a white European male.
I don't know this thing about his English. You see it except Italian. I don't ever hear Nick going, boy, I love fucking goddamn cabbage. He's fucking, he takes
I love
fucking
cabbage.
Italian.
Cabbage and potatoes.
He's a blue blood Italian
Irish.
Fucking hootity doody Sopranos guy. Fuck you. And you're another Italian. But I'm saying you band together to be this color. That's oppressive. It's not oppressive.
It's oppressive
color.
I'm pointing out things I'm seeing happening that is disproportionate.
Thank you.
It is not realistic. A lot of times I see things that are
and
not,
it's white
not
people,
indicative of what I see
right.
in society.
It's not realistic
they're
to your society.
They're portraying people of varying races in ways that are, it's not realistic.
It's actually...
Like what?
It's gone so far.
A fucking black pill lady?
Home invasion in a fucking alarm commercial. It should be a black guy.
Because
and you know that, Patrice. You're putting it through.
There's a disproportionate
Patrice
number
said that's
of
fair.
That's causing home true. Invasion. That's I'm fair just enough. Saying.
I am not afraid
Show
of white one. Guys. Fuck. But
white guy busting your door in, it better be fucking.
It's probably
a
because
Colombian.
He's found something that belongs to you, and he's returning it. He found money in the driveway, and he's bringing it back.
Here's another one.
Kick your door in to bring back your lawnmower. It's your neighbor.
There's one for insurance now. There's a white kid standing on a hill trying to take a picture with a black.
And
there's
bumbling.
And he falls down the hill. Oh, rolls down bumbling. The hill. What? And the black couple are looking
black
down, laughing
I've
at him.
Seen
you
that.
Think that's an
I've,
accident, you
yes,
dumb fuck?
I've grew up with that for years.
Yeah?
There's nothing but bumbling, white boys.
It's all bumbling.
And it's white people writing it. It's white liberals
know,
doing
yes,
it to other
yes.
white people.
But that's how you know. But that's how you know it's not an oppressive thing. It's
that's
a
right.
phony self-flagellation.
That's right. An oppressive no, I, thing. I never said it was black people
no.
Taking
right.
over television.
No.
They see, look, right. they see Obama got elected. They say, now we just got to put black people in every commercial.
That's,
in the,
that's been going on for... Hold
in
on,
a period
for a long time. There's a
yeah,
book.
Not
there's,
true. Not
that's
true.
It's in
the
writing. It's been legislated. Not the bell curve. Came out. I think Paved with Good Intentions by Jared Taylor. It's right in there. It's written into law. You have to represent black people in commercials. It's a law.
Is it a law?
Well, I'll find the book.
If it wasn't a law,
yes, dear.
Then we'd have fucking.
Baloney. You'd have plenty
have
of black.
We'd have Kentucky Fried Chicken commercials with no black people in it.
But
it'd
you got
just be
every,
white people
you got
enjoying.
Every McDonald's commercial now.
Oh my god!
Do you
god.
Realize
not
you have every
you
McDonald's
only see
commercial now?
A black and it's McDonald's a white commercial on BET
no
during a BET.
Way.
Where they
I
have a
never
jazz,
see a white
where they
have a, commercial.
Where they, it's only on black channels. Where they have
the
a jazzy.
Welcome to McDonald's. The new McRib making a comeback this week.
Hey baby, do you need a I had a hankering for a breakfast biscuit. How about you?
I ain't got a problem with that.
It's always a jazzy. Instead of
it's always a white girl. It's always a Midwestern white girl with a nice peaches and cream complexion working behind the counter at McDonald's. And the black people come. That's not how I've been seeing it. At the airport, it's some jaded chick with cornrows from Queens going, get your apple pie yourself, motherfucker.
That was Nick.
That was me. You goddamn right it was me.
Yeah, or your peach pie.
Oh, Chip.
Time to take a break.
Hey, you know yes, something, Patrice. Though? The thing about the black home invasion guy?
Yeah.
Or the white home invasion guy?
Yeah.
There are places where a white guy would home invade, but the way that the commercial... Wait,
bizarro world. Wait,
the way that commercial, you don't believe, where is this beautiful suburban home and this lady, and then there's a white guy tiptoeing around. But there are places where are some poor crackers.
I say that.
That busting your fucking house.
Patrice, I say that. But for every one white guy that does, it's about 400 black and brown people kicking in front of them.
That's not true.
Okay, 360.
That's not true.
Okay, 245.
But you know what? No, Patrice, this is why I don't agree. Because you know why it's being done. Even though you're right, there are white
that's
home
the,
invasion guys.
Of course.
You know. They're doing
you're talking
it.
About the context of the commercial.
You understand
the reasoning behind
the
it.
The reasoning behind
yeah,
it. And you can't
so
win the argument. Hold on. You can't win the argument in court because it's phony.
It's unrealistic.
Yeah. It's phony.
When the fuck did TV become real?
Hey, you gave us that one a few minutes ago. Now you're going back
but
and you're
unrealistic. Unrealistic
the home invasion thing. You gave us that one a few minutes ago.
It's
just
unrealistic
to make
for a reason.
Arguments. Yeah. It's all horseshit. Really.
It's unrealistic for a reason.
I'm scared of a nigga cutting my throat.
Underlying fear and guilt. It's he's there for that reason.
You gotta the people that don't understand the people who write this shit and produce it in Hollywood, movies, TV, sitcoms, commercial, you have to know what their agenda is and what their politics is. And it's ultra fucking liberal.
Yeah.
It taints everything they make, okay?
Exactly.
So that's all you need to know. Doesn't matter.
You know
at the end of the day, if it's a corporation, it's still a liberal agenda being pushed, okay? Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter if the commercials are corporate McDonald's. They still make money at the end of the day. But
you're a white guy without a fucking TV show, man. I don't understand that shit. That's what bugs me.
What are you talking about? I'm fucking like you. I'm brutally honest. You're a black guy who's not a movie star. That's more fucking incomprehensible. In this day and age, what are you doing wrong?
It's only two.
Jesus, my janitor at my high school's got a sitcom for Christ.
It's only two. What? Did you see Big Lake?
Were you in that?
Did you see
Big
Lake?
Did you play
Lake?
The lake? Wait, what is it? Big Lake. What is that?
I'm confused.
Why did somebody's finger hit that car crash? If this iced tea was hot.
Throw it in his face.
I don't know. What is Big Lake?
It's a Comedy Central show.
And it
oh yeah, they wanted me to write on it.
And
actually.
It just proves racism.
Really?
It's so bad that no black person could have a show that bad on television.
Really?
No, none ever. Could never.
I'll have to check
what's
never.
What's Big Lake about?
Yeah, oh, you have to fucking just
see it
watch
for yourself.
It. You'll be embarrassed.
It's about a lake that gets polluted by white corporations
as they pump in all their waste.
That would it would be better if it was that. That's a better idea.
I just look before we take a break. I just want to. I
ever.
Just want to see some commercials where a white guy
helps with pills.
Actually, tells a black person
what to do.
An
like
idea.
Usual?
No, not yeah, what to do. Just gives them an idea that the black guy goes, "Wow, hey, thanks."
Exactly.
That's good.
Exactly. Nice. The white guy had a good idea.
But
good
you know
idea.
What? Patrice is right, though. It's always, TV's always been phony. The fucking, the mom cooking the cake. You know, they don't show the fucking husband beating her.
Yeah, but that wasn't phony because it was a white lady.
No. But I'm saying, it's but now it's
Happy
just.
Happy Days was real.
Now it's just phony racially. It's always been phony, but now it's just phony racially.
It's always
racially.
Been slanted
but
culturally
it's the
to the
reason
left.
Behind it. I don't
right.
give a fuck.
Right.
It, as long as people were honest about the reason behind it. I understand why the fucking bumbling white guy's falling off the mountain as the black couple's chuckling yes. in their fucking beautifully dressed suits and everything like that. I understand.
Why does beautifully dressed suits?
Because
why
it's
why
that,
do you have to have
that
this
whole
sarcasm.
Scene. That whole scene is done
it
for a reason.
It makes you sick because you're white.
No. They should be purple with
no,
little hats.
It makes me sick because
me, for
it's
me,
someone's
I go,
agenda
what is this
being
bullshit?
Shoved down my throat. How about that commercial for the new fucking rock band where that white chick with the braces kisses the black guy and not, then
that
he's wearing
happen?
The braces? Huh?
That doesn't happen.
No, it should be blown up.
Will you just admit it, Anthony? Here's what, just admit that it bothers
I don't like
you
interracial
on a gut level. Yeah, just admit
that's
it.
That's not what
it
the
pro-
That
you.
Doesn't even bother me,
who
for Christ's sake.
I jerk off to it.
Who the fuck?
Patrice, you're so
Take
wrong
that
about
dot,
that, man.
Who the fuck notices this much shit about
Patrice.
Commercials?
That, it's shoving this fucking
liberal.
Issue,
it's
liberal
a fucking
agenda
liberal agenda, and it's
throat.
Worked, and that's how Obama got elected.
And it keeps going
white
and going
guilt.
And going. White
so,
guilt.
So now white guilt's
and
over
the,
just
and
in the 4 years that he
goddamn Obama
right.
got elected
of
because
shout.
Of fucking the dumb
did,
Republicans
did
picked Sarah Palin.
You hear what happens?
No, Jimmy, no way.
Obama's going to be gone, okay? So now it's like in two more years.
It wasn't just 4 years. It's been a work in progress for 40 years.
Now white guilt is now... All of a sudden, now it's gone.
Can I just say something?
Oh, my God. The white guilt is gone now.
I hope
after
so.
4 years. You know what?
Seriously.
You know what's, no, not I white guilt is gone.
What do you mean 4 years?
White honesty
it's been 40 years.
Is going to be, is now coming back.
Let
is
me it? Explain something
the
to
honest
Patrice.
White person.
Yes, that's right.
Let Nick explain.
The real,
ahead,
the real
white people are
oh,
coming.
Oh, shit. Look out.
There was a guy named Allen Ginsberg, okay? A real left-wing Joe! Radical. I'm too tired to go into this. I'm really the most well-read guy on this subject.
You sure
I know Ginsberg is.
I want
to
learn.
He used
go
to
ahead,
fuck,
Nick.
He did gigs with him.
Go ahead.
Go ahead no, Nick. He said in the 60s, okay? He said, we'll get your children, meaning we're going to invade the institutions, televisions, fucking college mm-hmm. campuses. And they did. For the last 40 years, it's been a liberal fucking agenda.
Yeah.
And it's brainwashed fucking white people and white kids and generations of them. And the white fucking guilt paid off and when Obama came along. You understand?
Yeah,
it's just simple. It's true as that.
Eat ass.
Come on, Patrice. You know I'm right.
Fooey and eat ass.
The liberal shit. Oh, you're right.
You
we're
said
doing
it was
to debate that fooey eat ass.
Yeah,
right.
Eat
back
ass.
To you, Nick. He no. said fooey.
College campuses are run by
least,
conservatives. You're right,
least,
Patrice.
At least fucking...
Hollywood's run by conservatives. You're right.
Is honest about his nonsense.
Yeah. It's not nonsense. Don't try to minimize
people,
what I say.
I'm going to marginalize it. So
you said minimize.
But I'm saying that these white people with this stuff that all of a sudden is this new white
literature.
People widening their eyes. It's nothing but white people getting permission to be what they really want to be.
See, he's saying
racist.
We're racist. You're racist. Black people are the most racist
so
people on the earth.
So fucking what? We should be flying planes into your fucking house.
You already did.
That's what the fuck we should
you
be doing, but we're
did.
Not. We walk around happy as a motherfucker.
Happy?
With what this country... Look it. What the fuck?
did black people do? You, after we come back, you tell me what the fuck we did to get still treated this fucked up. Never did anything.
Save that.
Getting
to you motherfuckers.
That's another hour easily. Save that.
I can't. This is getting.
Hold on.
I don't like this.
Let's get it. One day he would have been for saying that out loud.
Slavery,
there
Jim
you go.
Crow,
there you go.
Fucking civil rights, and then yesterday I wasn't getting hung.
Still.
Yesterday. And motherfucking white people talking about, black, the agenda. Shut the fuck up. White people are fucking racist.
And you have done more, okay, to make up for those slavery and all that
Thank
other.
God.
In the last 20 years, you've taken more out of this fucking country between court costs, fucking welfare,
what?
Reparations.
We've paid you a job.
We've paid you back 40-fold, motherfucker.
We who? Italians?
Yes.
You got here two days ago.
I'm a white European male.
You fucking helped put the lamp on the Statue of Liberty. That's what the fuck you did for this country.
And you
fucking nothing. Thanks for spaghetti. Yeah.
And you,
thanks for spaghetti, motherfucker. We appreciate it.
I'm English, too, by
thanks
the way.
Thanks for olive oil.
Yeah, what
and
you,
thanks for fried Mars bars from England. Thank you.
And you gave us the
Thank
club.
Thank you very much.
And you gave us the club.
Yes. Thank you.
That's the thing that goes on your steering wheel.
Yeah, that's a good line.
Oh, Dudley Moore would hate that joke.
Thanks for the ragu and the nice hats.
Well, you can always leave if you don't like it here. And boy, I'll tell you.
And you can leave too.
I am happy here.
Too many niggas. Let the 14% run wild. Ooga booga with our fucking bones in our nose and eat everybody. Shut the fuck up.
There aren't too many.
Sicking me with your
horseshit. There aren't too many. There aren't too many black. There are not.
300 million races walking around.
See, that's it. That's what they're doing. They can't win the argument. You got to throw
it. Oh, really?
That's
oh,
all
really?
You do.
You've
fucking
been making
name
really
call.
Wise things. Shut the fuck. No, you haven't.
Look how crazy you are right now.
Because it's you can't
I
prove
hit
it.
The nail on the head. I hit the nail on the head.
You hit the nigga with a fucking plunger. That's what you did. You shot the nigga 41 times.
Oh, don't use that word. We're going to get in trouble.
That was Patrice.
That might be the best
Patrice.
Show I've ever been a part of. By the way, I'm
amazing.
At Foxwoods.
Yeah, let's do this, yes. Nick. Go ahead. Big
By
plug
the way,
for Foxwoods
folks,
this weekend.
Foxwoods, tonight, Friday night, Saturday night. For tickets, comics, comix, at foxwoods.com or 1-800-200-2882. Yeah. And Saturday night, come up.
Yeah, let's get a lot of people at Nick's fucking show.
It should be great.
He's filming a DVD. We got to fill up the joints.
And
Nick,
I love
right?
The Indians
exactly,
are terrific up there.
What exactly is the taping? What is it, one taping, two taping?
Yeah, two.
On Saturday, so both shows filled up.
So you got to wear the same shit? You got two of everything, though?
No, I don't, actually.
Oh, really?
I was going to wear a different shirt just to screw up the whole
thing. You might as well.
Yeah, one minute. Yeah, one. The setup, I'm in a red shirt, and then the punchline, I'm in a tuxedo.
Right, that would be honest, at least. And Patrice at Bananas this weekend, right? Hasbro Heights, New Jersey.
I'm not going to make a joke about that.
Friday and Saturday night for Patrice O'Neill. What's the question as we go on a break that we're going to answer after the break?
What? Seriously. What has black people done to this country to get treated so
poorly? I agree,
poorly.
Patrice. You were pulled over here against the will.
Opie and Anthony with Patrice O'Neill and fucking Nick DiPaolo today. These guys are giving us amazing radio. Let's not forget Nick DiPaolo filming that big DVD in Foxwoods this weekend, starting tonight, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. But you want to sell all the shows out, not just the DVD taping.
But especially Saturday, but yeah.
Especially Saturday?
Yeah.
Okay.
But, sure.
Why wouldn't you go see Nick DiPaolo at Foxwoods? That's a great time.
Because I voted for Obama and I wouldn't put up with his shit. That's why.
Yes.
I'm a closed-minded twat.
I think once you get a certain age, you lose a little potency. I feel it leaving. I feel I don't have the...
Really? You don't have the fight in you?
I know. Like, just that made my head light. That fucking... I got a light, like a bright spot came in my eye.
That's your diabetes.
And
really?
But I can hear Nick... Nick is a kinder, gentler. He still has his Nickness, but you can feel.
We just heard a little bit. I hate
a gentler Nick DiPaolo.
Yeah,
so you think it's
Nick
like
Nick has to take a nap after
the
Nick
old
could
dogs.
Do this.
The old dogs.
Nick
nap.
Used to be able to fucking do that all day today and tomorrow.
Right.
And then eat, but still do it while he was eating. You
he's
can
still
see,
got a point, actually.
Is he the aging
see,
athlete?
Yeah.
Still being it.
Nick's
he's able to do
Nick's
it, but he needs the downtime.
He needs a racial racial reconstruction. You can hear it. Nick, look.
He's still scoring 30 points, but he needs like a four-hour nap afterwards.
You know what
now.
Nick needs? It's like a protege. It's And that's the same thing with me. You just go, oh.
You need a little positive reinforcement is what you need. Mm. And here's the deal. You know, I'd like to get a radio show, terrestrial. I come on here and I say this shit. It goes on the internet. It's in perpetuity forever.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Who's going to, they can go Google me now if I go to get a job at a legitimate and go, oh, he called Patricia Black, blah, 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 and I'm hung for good. So fuck everybody.
Like, completely out of context.
Yeah, out of context. Sure. Exactly. Yeah, so you know what?
Nick has never used the word, blah, 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 blah. It's nigger.
I've never said.
See, now that's I'm fucking with you, Nick. Do you see what happened? Do you see if this was Roots? Yeah. Nick is close to changing his name.
Wow.
To fucking Toby.
Really?
But I'm not. This is not disrespect.
That's a horrible thing to say.
Wait a minute. It's not
I'm Master Moa till I die. Yeah.
This coming from Raw Foods George.
I was getting ready to say that
we
about me.
We talking about cauliflower.
Chicken fucking, I'm telling you, my back hurts.
Chicken wings, George.
Yes. Hey, my chicken fingers, back hurt. I'm close to going,
you know
okay.
What? I'm not even going to argue the point.
My name is Toby. Because they beat you down.
It's that athlete thing. I feel like I got to go in for Jim Crow shoulder surgery.
You will Jim Crow 10 minutes to say that.
Jesus.
Well, all right, what's the question? I forgot already.
Oh, we are all done.
Yeah.
You're done?
Yeah, he's right. You know what? He's right. Exhausting. I couldn't argue another half hour.
It is exhausting.
It's just done. We're done.
That's what those people do to you.
There's some kind of
You mean the radio people?
Yeah. In my city, we would keep it in their neighborhoods.
We got a hot blonde on TV, a new one. Locally, she's
what
all right.
The fuck
that's
is
a
she
Fox
doing?
Girl. That's Court. That's you know.
Really? Courtney Friel.
Yeah,
damn. She
she's
looks
pregnant.
Good.
She's pregnant, obviously.
Really?
Yeah, she's much hotter than
she
that.
She looks good.
You should. She when she's not. She go Google
she's
her, man.
Knocked up.
They got her in bikinis on. If you Google her, she's
a girl like that. I'd be happy to knock up just by throwing my cum at her.
Whoa! Look at those jerseys.
Ah, these Jersey Shore bars. That fucking Snooki is disgusting.
I don't get it. I don't
think her pussy is fat, though. After a shower, she probably has a nice pussy.
Everything on her is fat. She's a little fire plug. Yuck. Disgusting.
I find Snooki to be sexier than this broad you're talking about on TV, right?
Really?
Get the fuck out
No, but that broad on TV, that's as bad as
like,
she can
Snooki's
look.
Snooki's like, has
your
a little pig.
Got your eyes.
It's fucking with my eyes. She's a little pig. I like little
pigs. She is a little pig.
I like little
pigs. Snooki's a better fuck than the girl on Fox, because she's a nice girl.
No, Google her. No, she's a, I'm telling you.
There's nothing sensual about her. You don't want to kiss this lady.
Yeah, I do.
She got, you know, she did, she got veneers. She fucked up her teeth. She got veneers, and her mouth is open.
Yeah.
But Google her
Those
and look at her.
Thin baloney lips. Like, what are you going to do with her?
Thin baloney lips.
They're a mess. She's a mess.
What do you want to kiss a big mouth bass? Nice.
Sometimes. Sometimes.
Did you check out Rent is Too High? Rent is Too Damn High guy?
Who's that?
Jimmy McMillan.
He's everywhere.
Jimmy McMillan is
the karate expert guy.
He's the candidate for governor.
Yeah, and he's paying $800 himself.
No, well, now they're saying he's rent-free for 10 years.
He's rent-free for 10 years.
Oh,
is the
new one.
It's the latest
expose.
That's
the new one.
Well, you don't have to be paying high rent.
He told the paper $800.
No, you're right.
You don't
That's
have
true.
To be paying high rent to fight for other
That's
people
true,
not to
Jimmy.
Pay it.
That's true, Jimmy. That's
true. Because no politician's actually in the pickle of the people they're trying to help.
Exactly.
None of them are.
Hey, that was well put.
The Post is trying to fucking target this guy because they know that they picked Cuomo. It's amazing that they're actually the nerve of the Post to endorse a fucking
I know.
Endorse any newspaper
I know.
To endorse a candidate and then fucking write negative shit about another one. The nerve of any of these motherfuckers.
That Dicker, that Fred Dicker, that fucker. He's the one who went after Paladino.
Is the mayor infinite amount of times you can serve?
I do. I love
it. No, I think
it used to be until faggot Bloomberg changed it back.
Two term.
It was Koch had three, and then it went to two. Dinkins served one. Rudy served two, and he wanted to serve a third after 9/11. And guys like Bloomberg were like, "No,
Bloomberg
the process must carry on."
Yeah.
And then Bloomberg fights to get a third one for himself.
Yes.
He's been around way longer than fucking 8 years.
It's been around 2001.
Yeah, it'll be his 12th year.
Bloomberg.
That's three terms.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
I just said that. He fought to have a change. He
three terms.
He spent $100 million to be the mayor.
Mm-hmm.
So how the fuck is that fair?
So is it going to go four turn? Is it infinite now? It's just three.
I think it's three.
He's done.
Unless he goes, I want another one.
I'm reading the icons.
Is he beloved mayor, this guy?
He did one good thing, and that was calorie counts. Because I like the fact that the companies didn't put them up.
He just did that yesterday. Like,
the guy's a liberal ass.
Yeah, he is. He couldn't get on the Republican.
Putting in on every other state
Democrat
for their gun laws.
I think he's a goo gobbler, too.
Yeah.
A lot of people have speculated that. But
I'll go.
Goo gobbler. Goo gobbler.
He's a fucking goo gobbler.
Oh,
we have a we have a terrible budget gap, and the bad news is I had to close 5 firehouses. But the good news is you can stay at my place, fellas. You can stay at my place. I like the bike paths.
It's the same fucking mayor too that after the fucking they find a bomb in Times Square. He goes, "Who knows who it could be? It could be somebody unhappy with the healthcare reform."
Exactly.
Oh, you fucking blithering
some
idiot.
Kind of
shut
militia
up.
Guy,
that's where he really fucking.
That did it for me.
Yeah, it's not a Muslim. No,
No.
It's a white guy unhappy with healthcare reform.
Yeah, it's a guy from It's a guy from Applebee's who got thrown out.
What a fucking funny asshole he is.
Can I make a fucking public apology to Nick DiPaolo, please?
Yeah, go ahead, Patricia.
Nick, I'm sorry if I for any second said that you got beat out of being Nick. When with such naturalness... He goes goo goblin mayor. The mayor's a goo. I think he's a goo goblin. Jesus Christ almighty.
I'm reading
fucking Nick, man.
I love the show because I got the computer screen in front of me and I'm reading your icons.
Don't read the icons.
Camel puss. Balls and ass. Hitler. Something.
They're all Danny. Yeah,
those are our top topics.
I love the show.
When you're not here, that's where we go. Camel pussy.
Oh, shit. Bloomberg is a fucking asshole. Socially, he is.
Yeah, I think he's a phony.
He really is a nanny, isn't he?
He's in nannies trying to
salt
get
salt and cigarettes and
yeah. That
the fuck is that?
And then the just trotting around from state to state that he has nothing to do with as this mayor for illegal guns off the street. and meanwhile, by doing that, he's legislating against legal gun owners.
He's trotting around.
He's trotting around gobbling goo.
He's skipping.
A goblin goo trotting.
Yeah.
Trotting around goo goblin mayor for New York City. What the fuck is it? I feel like my life's in danger right now.
Trotting.
I don't even know if
I can say that.
I just want to join in, too. Just fucking. But it's just like.
I don't know if you could say that in the year 2010.
Everybody's getting tickets this fucking week.
No kidding.
I'm not parking on this. I'm just going to fucking stay in the house.
When I leave here, I get a feeling I'm going to go to the parking garage. There's going to be a boot on all four wheels. He's on a computer right now tracking my Garner.
How do you spend $100 million to get elected and a guy who might be
well,
better
because he
qualified?
Has $5 billion.
How is that allowed? Yeah. How is that allowed?
The people allow it.
Well, that's freedom of speech, man. Yeah.
It's like a fucking,
it's a I don't have a problem with that.
Yeah. He could spend his money.
But that's why we're getting shitty candidates who have only that interest in mind.
I know.
They're the ones who can afford to run.
Well, that's true, but I don't want the guy that picks up my trash running either.
But people don't look at Obama as... Obama's an elitist. Like, people don't think because he's black that he can be an intellectual elitist.
Exactly.
He's a snob. He's like all those guys. He's no different.
That's the white side of him.
But I love how this was going to be change and not business as usual.
Yeah.
And what's he doing? He's thrown away working as the president to campaign for all of his friends around the fucking country. That's called business as fucking
usual.
He's
a Harvard elitist.
Yeah, yeah. White people have done this for years.
That's a very good point.
But his whole
it really
point,
is.
No, his whole point
is it's business as usual. He's right.
But his whole point was,
I hate when the fucking president
is. Change. When you have change behind you, that's a big
but you know what, Anthony?
Well, the president has no power to change anything. What president?
Yeah, he can veto. Sure he does.
Change is nothing.
But you know what?
Not that much.
Well, he kind of got Nikki Barnes arrested.
Barnes!
For that incident in Vietnam?
No, Nikki Barnes, the heroin kingpin, for the cover story he did on the Sunday New York Times Magazine, Mr. Untouchable.
For Sergeant Barnes.
No, the other Sergeant Barnes was good. Wow, did we just ruin this conversation? I started destroying it, and you hopped right on. My apologies.
I was afraid to chime in. I had no idea what was going on over there.
We're just fucking.
We can talk about the Gooch. Bob Guccione dead.
What?
But what do you do with that?
Yeah,
you don't know. Last
dead.
Night,
yeah,
cancer, 79, Dallas, Texas.
Yep.
It's a shame.
There's a lot worse ways to die than Dallas.
You like Penthouse over Playboy, Nick? We were discussing that earlier.
I don't look at that shit anymore.
Growing up,
I used to National Geographic. The lady carrying wood on her head with a saggy black tip. That's what I used to get off to.
Growing up was huge. That's that little kid from fucking...
Who's that?
Little Miss Sunshine?
Nah, that's yeah. Little Miss Sunshine kid.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you could tell.
Abigail Breslin.
Yeah,
you could tell.
Yeah, she got a couple of years. Yeah,
she's got a face on like a corpse.
Oh, she looks like a fucking Hummel.
That's a horrible face.
Hummel!
He's right. No features.
Nice skin.
I'm just perplexed like at what white people like and don't. I look at her.
It's not all white people.
I don't like her. I'm looking at her going...
She's horrible.
I thought you guys were going to go, oh,
Aunt was thinking youth. That's
no,
all.
No, I'm just thinking, nah, I'm like
Kirsten Dunst with her teeth that come out of her face. Tooth.
I never get that one either.
I don't get it. Don't get it.
I don't get that one
that's
either. Or Reese Witherspoon. I don't get
it. I get her, but she doesn't do anything.
I don't.
Reese Witherspoon.
I will, just to prove that I'm not so racist. Mm-hmm. I'll give you my top three sexiest white women of all time.
Oh, mm-hmm. Shit.
Helen Thomas.
Three.
Number three.
Phyllis Schlafly.
Adrienne Barbeau.
Wow. All right.
Oh, Adrienne. I love her. Yes. Oh, my God.
She's like the big titty.
Two. She was sexy,
only because
though.
She fucked a guy on your
two.
Level.
Amy Smart.
Yeah. Amy Smart.
Amy Smart.
One of those kidnapped?
The New Hampshire girl.
Yeah, that one. Yeah,
I don't know who the other one is.
And JonBenet Ramsey. Amy Smart.
JonBenet Ramsey.
A bunch of movies. No, you're thinking Amy Smart was New Hampshire. Had her husband killed,
no,
right?
No.
No, there's an Amy Smart actress.
Amy Smart, who was in Hangover. No.
Oh, I'm thinking of Elizabeth Smart. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're thinking
of Elizabeth. I'm
sorry. Oh, it's cute, by the way.
The Transporter. She played the. Have you seen The Transporter?
Megan Fox.
Not The Transporter.
You know if you saw it.
I don't know
exactly.
I'm serious.
What's the one where he had to live?
Helen Reddy.
Yeah.
He had to live.
Shane.
That one with the fucking
adrenaline.
Heart adrenaline. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's Jason Statham. Whatever his shitty movies.
Crank.
Go. Speed. Slow down.
Crank.
I'll get a fucking
Amy
run.
Smart
quick.
Fly.
She's pretty hot.
And number one is Janet from Three's Company.
Are you kidding me?
Joyce DeWitt?
Yeah, come on, see, that's another kidding. Way of just being mean.
You're just being
mean. You don't mean
that.
You're
much better.
That's his way of saying white
Amy
woman ain't
Smart
that hot. That's all he's doing.
Janet from Three's Company.
She was sexy.
You have a type.
Janet?
You're doing a bit.
You have a type that's as far as white women go.
That's a bit.
Yeah, mediocre type.
Mediocre.
What he's saying is these mediocre broads are the best you can do in the white.
Fucked out.
Adrienne Barbeau didn't do anything for
you.
She had big fat tits.
Who's number one for
I'll give you my three top black women.
She got a bullet in her head in Creep Show.
The problem is, though, I'll tell you that I think fucking Carly Simon's hot, too.
Really? With that steam shovel
with that
jaw?
Big mouth,
I'm going to give you my three top black women. Esther Rolle. Shirley Hemphill.
Shirley Hemphill.
And Mabel King and before Mabel the legs went fucking kablooey.
Well, that's where we part ways. Yeah.
Can you put Precious in there, Nick, please?
Precious.
There you
Precious
go.
Precious's mom.
She's so talented. Let's overlook her obesity.
Thank you for saying that, Nick. I've been nailed with the label that I don't find any black women attractive, and we've been through a bunch of them, and I go,
I don't either, really. That's not a racist thing.
I found one, actually a couple in one video. That fucking motherfucking CeeLo fuck you video, which is hysterically funny, has like hot girls in it.
Can we get that on
there's
the
there's like
on the
there's like hot
so
hot.
Obscure nigglets. Give me a fucking a hot black woman. And and don't say Halle Berry.
She does.
She's
not black saying Halle Berry. I think Halle Berry is a fucking man.
Let me tell you something.
No, she's
that
sexy,
woman.
Dude.
I think it's not.
She is.
She's an white woman. I know you didn't approve of Joyce DeWitt.
That was not a joke?
No.
That's not amazing.
I find Janet from Three's Company to be sexy. Back when she was Janet.
Wow, that's
but I'm look it, but I've proven that I give white women a look, and I give them respect for being what
wow,
I think
really
they are.
Wow, you're really busting a stereotype.
By naming three of the most mediocre ones.
What I'm saying, but Suzanne Somers, I know she's a sexy woman. Like, okay. Mm-hmm.
Give us some black
I'll
women.
I'll give you a black one.
We should think it.
And after this, I find like a lot of the Bond girls to be gorgeous.
I
find a lot of those girls to be
give
beautiful.
Us your top three black women. We're going to look at it. Right now on the screen.
My top three black women that you would
over.
Know?
Yeah. Oh, why?
I like a lot of those big video girls, and I like porn stars, but...
Mainstream shit.
Zoe Saldana is a pretty girl.
All right, slow down. That's we're going to look her up.
No, he's going to look up
the CeeLo shit?
I actually think...
hold on. These are
hot.
The chicks that Ant likes.
Now, go forward to the high school years and then the college years girl is kind of hot. You kind of,
ooh,
not
these,
not these singers, not these.
What? See that?
No.
They just showed a 12-year-old.
Keep going. No, that's not her. See, he's growing up.
Oh, okay.
See, and then when you get to this, okay. Now the chick that's sitting at the table.
All right, hold on. We're almost is, there.
Great song, by the way. I know.
What were they filming? Is it Johnny Rockets?
It looks like it, right? Now look at the chick to the left.
Wow, she's
that
very
chick
curious.
Is fucking hot. Right. Then you see a little more of her and stuff.
I kind
of
like the one on the right.
With the glasses,
I like the one on the right. Either, believe me. There's nothing wrong with her either.
And it's just she's enough half, white. She's half Chinese too.
You think?
That's why she's not all black.
Half Chinese.
Yeah, white. You need it mixed with
well, half the next white. One for the college years too is hot.
He means black women like the ones fucking Fishburne was dating in school days.
Yeah, these girls are barely black.
Yeah.
Well, that's the key. I'll give you my number one black woman.
That's right.
Man, turn this horseshit off.
Yeah, never
that. We gotta find Anthony's obscure niggas.
She ain't bad, but then
they're all pretty
it's
hot out there.
They all look
for video
good.
Chicks.
And yeah.
I'm not big on the chocolate myself, you. But.
Now, wait, watch
how
this
the
girl.
Fuck, you guys this are shit. Amazing, man.
No, why? You fucking said Joyce DeWitt. Give me a break.
Yeah.
Why can't Joyce DeWitt be fucking fly?
I don't think there's a white guy alive that right would here. Put
now
her,
this
her in his top three.
I guarantee you get some money.
That chick's
right
hot.
There.
Yeah, she's
there's
hot.
Nothing
that's
wrong with that girl.
Two-thirds white.
The chick who played Sunshine in
right?
fucking Harlem Nights. Very sexy black
that's
woman.
That's a black chick.
I'll give you my favorite black chick of all time.
Who's the hottest black chick?
Wait, I'll tell you who
let's
it is.
Go with
Thelma from Good Times.
Yeah, she was
Thelma.
Hot.
Thelma,
she was
turned,
a ghetto.
And I will say,
stole
I'll, give
that
you,
Playboy.
I'll give you credit.
She was sexy.
Right?
Yes.
I loved
stole
her.
Stole that Playboy.
Thelma from,
when I was a kid.
Thelma from Good Times. Mm-hmm. Also Chaka Khan, too. But I was saying white woman.
Chaka.
Young Chaka Khan.
How about this, bro?
Oh, Stacey Dash is in. She's phenomenal.
Holy shit.
She's 43 years old, man.
She's got a tan, for Christ's sake. She's not even black.
Yeah, she's barely black. I've
dated Dr.
Italian.
Oh, that's
the chick, the daughter from fucking Lethal Weapon? Is that her?
Holy
no,
that's
not,
that. Not black. You call that black?
She's 10% black.
That's
my sister's
black.
A darker.
Stacey Dash
looks like
mom.
Miley Cyrus. Get
but
out of here.
Exactly. Every girl looks like that now. You don't get no fucking African girls no
you
more.
You don't want? Yeah.
Oh, good God. God. Good God.
Is that real?
Look at those.
Is that real?
How
are
old
you
is she there?
Are you kidding me?
How old is she there, Patrice? What'd you guess?
She's 43 14. Now.
These are 43-year-old picks we're looking at?
No. I don't know if she's that age now.
She's
I mean, she's that in this picture. But she's 43 now and she looks the same.
She'd have a little doo-doo hanging out of that picture. That'd be funny. What's the point? Just a turd sticking out.
Wouldn't scare me at all.
Just the head sticking out looking around.
Push it back in with your tongue.
She could do fucking four girls in one cup, nigga. I wouldn't give a fuck.
Like a Manx cat with a little shit tail sticking out.
Doesn't matter.
And you flick your tongue on it.
There's too many to speak of, though. There's too many seconds. But
give me a couple
Thelma,
more.
Thelma from Good Times is absolutely...
And she was dark, too, man.
But she was like, if you ask any black man, like, who's the one?
What
is
a
Thelma
black.
For
and that
Thelma.
Came from me, Patrice.
Yeah. That's why I give you credit, because Thelma's a black girl.
She's yeah,
black.
She was
like
ghetto.
Official.
That body, I put that body against... I was a
Barbara,
teenager,
Barbara,
and I was
Barbara,
wearing
Ringo
it up.
Ringo Starr's wife is one of the best
she was
looking women.
In James Bond.
I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah.
I think she's the number one Bond girl that ever lived.
Yeah, that was a good one.
She's gorgeous. Gorgeous yep. white woman.
I like the mother on Everybody Loves Raymond, too. Helen Thomas. What's her name?
Helen...
The mother.
Y'all really got upset with that one from Good... I mean, with
Joyce DeWitt.
DeWitt.
That DeWitt. Doesn't make sense.
She's
it's a silly
just,
choice.
I don't even think black guys would put that in the top three.
He's just busting a ball.
White guys certainly would.
I
look
think
at
black
her.
Guys,
look at this shit.
Get
what's the matter? Look at her nose.
She looks like an
look
aging clown.
Why would you show the picture
she's
got she
Michael,
looks like?
She's got Michael Jackson nose.
She looks like Skeletor.
Right.
What happened? Real
why is the worst
she fuck her
ever?
She
what happened
her
to her nose?
She fucked her nose.
Is that cocaine, you think?
She fall asleep on a panini maker? Look at her hair. Is that her there, too?
Kind of fucking old.
Oh, she's awful.
Holy shit. Oh. Buy one from Three's Company.
You sure you didn't mean Mrs. Roper?
Yeah, I was going to say. Exactly, Jimmy.
Holy shit.
You guys are pieces of shit. I'm telling you.
She's
stunning.
You're
right.
The fuck John
she's
Knox.
Right. Look
pick
at
up
her.
The fucking I'm sexy picture, you piece of shit.
You're not going to win anyone
she's
over.
She's dumb looking.
She sucks.
Did you like her ass, Patrice?
She wouldn't even be in my top 1,000.
She's beautiful.
Top 1,000.
Look at her. She looks like a Russian cab driver in that picture. And messy hair and a tank top.
Patrice, you got the Google images in front of you. You pick out a picture where she's fucking hot.
I'm going to show you something.
Yeah,
you we're, like on the, body
we're on the eighth third, page.
Yeah, we're really rocking through these pages.
We're back to her baby pictures.
She used to wear these jeans, man. She used
really?
To, she used to look good in jeans.
Jordash.
Hey, you lost me, Patrice.
She just...
You're fucking... Look, Danny's trying every combination to find a hot picture.
Who else you like? Barbara Billingsley?
You motherfuckers.
God rest her soul, Mrs. Yes, Cleaver.
Of course. And I thought the
That's not a bad body though.
And I thought the second
the second blonde.
The second Cindy was the second Suzanne Summers.
She was a porn star, right?
The middle.
That was the real
Wait, wait, wait.
There was a tall, goofy one. I thought she was sexy too.
She was a porn star, supposedly.
That the was fuck was the other one's name?
Maybe
Patrice Matron.
Maybe when I was little,
You're losing.
All right, what's that? What's that picture?
What the hell is her name?
What's that one?
Jenna Lee Harrison.
You know who was sexy also?
Is that the blonde?
No,
Valerie Bertinelli.
Yes, looked just like my first girlfriend.
Way better than Joyce DeWitt.
All right, we'll go with Bertinelli, but I'm bumping up Adrian Barbeau to one.
Adrian Barbeau.
Let's go old school. I want to see a picture of
Adrian Barbeau.
She was unbelievable.
Fucking ridiculous. Natural
hits, by the way.
How was she getting shot and escaped from New York?
Oh, my God.
Did you like her in Maud?
Where did she get run over?
The Maud years?
She had ridiculous heavy tits.
She had those giant natural tits.
Natural
tits. They're just heavy.
And look at that. She was
hot. Fucking face. She's a wreck. She's as not pretty as fucking Joyce DeWitt.
It was the heavy.
Nah, she was kind of pretty in her
Look at her big fucking heavy tits.
I don't know.
What the fuck is going on in that picture, Danny?
I'll tell you something.
Holy
look at those.
Shit.
Look at those.
And that's why... If Janet had a bunch of shit like that with her tits out and her pussy cocked, you'd be like, "Ooh, Janet." But
Janet had two things like that, tits. She doesn't.
Yeah, that's the point.
She had a fucking mullet.
Go to Amy Smart too. The only one in the top three that. I mean, your top three is not that great, Patrice.
I love it.
That's his way of zinging us. Don't you understand that?
You think Amy Smart? He picked you really give most, me that much credit?
He picked the three most mediocre white women.
That girl looks mediocre.
No,
to you?
She's pretty hot.
Nah,
she's
nah,
a beautiful
nah,
girl.
Nah, she's
and you bo- and you agree with Adrian Barbeau?
A little bit.
You know?
A little bit.
No, but you threw him DeWitt to fuck us up.
No, yeah, I like
DeWitt. And the Barbeau was all about the tits, not the face. So
I like the girl in the Three Stooges, the blonde that used to get hit with a monkey wrench in the face. You know what I'm talking about?
Your top three sucks. It really was not good.
Dorothy Hamill was in my top ten.
All hands love birds.
Dorothy Hamill, I was in love with.
Dorothy Hamill?
When I was 14,
I
skipped baseball practice. I faked an injury to watch her skate on fucking Wild World.
Did you, jacket?
I had a TV guide I saved.
White women that white guys go crazy over, I don't find to be that attractive. Like, I like white women to have, like, something else going on.
Patrice,
she
had an ass in the corner.
Patrice, who do you think we go crazy for as white guys?
Connecticut housewife.
That's a good question.
Who do you think we go crazy over?
Dorothy's still hot.
I'll tell you a fucking high-level white bitch Megan Fox.
She has a nice body.
She's a smoking white woman.
She has a great body.
She's
naturally gorgeous.
She has an ET thumb.
There is something wrong with thumb. It's not my ass.
Why get that, Patrice?
Yeah, I don't understand that.
You're right.
Sorry, dude.
Who's there?
I know she's sexy, but I'm saying it does nothing.
Why would you get it?
That does nothing.
Oh, you don't like
that?
You
don't like
that? Whatever. I mean, the sarcasm I get, but it does nothing for me. I couldn't jerk off to that.
How about if she was hanging out with Jack Tripper? I could do that.
He'd get a threesome with Joyce DeWitt.
Look,
then you would spend more time with Joyce DeWitt.
I have a conversation with my boy, right? He goes, is this girl pretty? I go, eh. And he goes, but would you fuck her? I go, that has nothing to do with it.
Of course.
Fucking Megan Fox, of course. She's
don't look
she's
at her
gorgeous.
Thumb, her thumbs
she's
are
gorgeous to the eye,
because
beauty's what it is. But she
Nick, look at
does
her thumb,
she does
look at her
nothing
thumb.
For
What's
me.
The matter with
her thumb? Who cares about it? I'd suck her thumbs and jerk off.
What? There's only one thing wrong with that thumb. It's not up my ass.
I'm sorry.
She has toe thumbs.
What did she get? It caught in a lathe?
I don't know what the fuck it is.
No,
man.
It's a toe thumb. It's a weird.
What happened to her? Right.
Just a birth defect. She has it on both thumbs.
It's some weird thumb.
I kind of have the same.
I wouldn't date her now, so I should make fun.
She's just a white girl, man.
It's too close to home.
She can't even hitchhike
just
to my
nothing,
house.
There's nothing.
All right, give us another
nothing
one.
Nothing happening, dude.
Patrice, wow. Another one.
Yeah, that's a shit
that, that probably you guys will go maybe crazy over?
Well, you think white guys go crazy over that you don't get?
That will be anybody.
Shit.
A lot. Like,
Megan Fox was
in one. I'll name
one. Go ahead.
You know who I think's really smoking? The money girl, Maria Bartiromo.
Oh, don't get it, really?
The money honey?
Yeah.
Maria Bartiromo.
Yeah. You like the same.
I like that.
You just like that
Barbie bone in the stomach kind of weird.
No, no, Nick just picked one that's not that.
Exactly. Why do you always got to generalize and paint with a broad brush?
You know, I don't know.
He picked it.
You know I never thought was hot?
Refuted,
you know I never thought was hot? Pam Anderson. Never fucking thought she
was. Oh, my God. Before she got her shit done, she was hot.
That's right.
Fake, blonde, I do get it, but I don't
think Anthony, you're right, though. But when she, when they discovered her.
She was ridiculously hot.
Oh, my God. Before she got the
fucked it up.
And
the big lips. And the big fucking
fake lips. No, but she. Ever look at her when she first got famous?
It was too plasticky, fakey.
No, you know who was sexy?
Madeline Stowe was sexy. Remember Madeline Stowe?
Shut up.
She was fucking sexy, man. Yeah.
Go with Pam Anderson
Madeline
before.
Stowe was fucking sexy.
When she was discovered.
N.B. Davis.
They run together. Like, Hollywood doesn't let anybody but Megan Fox. Like, it's a bunch of Megan Foxes out there.
What do you mean? She's a brunette with beautiful eyes and beautiful skin. She's a naturally gorgeous.
There's no ugly. White hot. Women in Hollywood? What ugly white famous?
No. What are you talking about? That dykey woman in Glee, she gets every fucking role because she's got a cock.
What's that? That's Jane funny. Lynch. She's funny, though.
I know, but I'm just saying. You said every funny. White woman she's a fucking white man.
She's not in shit because she's fucking pretty. Jane
Lynch
she's funny.
Is fucking funny.
She's a funny broad, man.
She really is.
She's terrific.
But she has to be.
Did you look at Nick's?
No, she doesn't. She's in Hollywood. She eats snatch. That's all it takes. Everybody in casting is gay.
How do you know she's a fucking dyke?
Oh, I don't know. I see the outline of her cock and her pants.
Are you saying you got to gobble the goo in Hollywood?
Yeah, and she doesn't. She likes fresh salmon steaks.
Look, I can't. Where's these other girls? These other Hollywood.
Well, the one Nick picked was totally different.
Yeah, but no one heard of that fucking girl. What's she in? What's she in?
She was huge.
She's in
nothing. And she's still on TV.
Who are we talking about now? I'm lost.
The Money Honey.
But oh, Maria
Bartiromo.
Will you please name like a white girl that's in movies?
Almost like a Sophia Loren a little bit.
Okay, put
eyes.
It this way. There'll never
a little bit,
be a
little
fucking
bit.
Black.
She's getting older, though.
A black.
Always comes back to this one.
Yeah. Always comes back. It's never too far from you.
It always comes back to racism with you.
There'll never be a black.
There'll never be a black.
Because you're shitty actors.
What's the girl from
Guest
the
at Anthony's house?
really?
The girl from Batman.
Pause it too much.
Alicia Silverstein.
What?
Alicia Silverstein?
From Batman.
No.
Black?
She was funny.
This one, Dark Knight.
Oh.
I don't know. Maggie
Gyllenhaal.
There'll never be a black woman. There'll never be a black woman passed off
as
that
hot.
Bitch. Like, a black woman that looks that unsexy would never be passed off.
They were shoving her down her throat like she's a hot blonde.
Exactly. But that's
terrible.
What I'm saying.
Who?
That's why I get confused with you fucking
here's
people.
Here's what I'll give you.
She's not even hot.
I am sick of fucking Latifah being shoved down my throat like she's fucking hot.
Right.
And stop
straight.
It.
No,
right.
She's
and
not
stop
straight,
it.
By the way.
Stop it. Revlon commercials like she's a cover girl.
Right.
Fuck you.
No, they always.
Call my pool girl.
Again, it's her politics.
Yes.
Ivy League black woman. Lesbian, by the way.
Like
they
she would get the athlete in real life.
As
was that
a big, anyway? A big black girl
but
that's
she,
pretty.
But she's, no, she's presented
but she's
as
a pretty
a
woman,
diva.
She's
not
a pretty.
Pretty
woman.
She's to sell products to
she's
fat chicks, though.
She's not pretty.
She's
Latifah's
telling
a pretty woman, man.
No, they're not. They are presenting her as, look at this beautiful.
That's a pretty woman.
Not a big, beautiful
Game
woman.
No.
Right.
Just a beautiful
woman. Scarlett Johansson, Game
Revlon.
Thank you, Dan.
Yeah, Scarlett Johansson.
Who is that?
Scarlett Johansson.
Hey, we're forgetting one. Charlize Theron.
That's a pretty woman.
Yeah.
She's
a fucking stunner.
Charlize Theron.
That is a pretty woman.
I met her on
Queen
the Tonight
Latifah?
Show.
Show the red picture, Danny.
Latifah is always being shown as like a hot
but she's
girl.
A pretty woman, though.
She's all right.
She's a pretty
she's
woman.
She's not
though.
A pretty woman.
What show about Latifah, Jada Pinkett please. Smith?
You like that?
You know what?
Vivian Fox.
I think Jada Pinkett Smith looked good in Matrix.
You, look at see this here?
How is this a pretty woman?
Listen, man. This is walk
us through
woman.
This.
This is that disrespect.
She's a gay Ivy Leaguer. That's what they love about her.
Look at that. Those tits and
that's,
that face.
That's 20 years ago.
That's a fucking.
She don't look anywhere near
she got,
that.
She got all
she's
the
in the same category as
right
the fucking.
That's who you think's hot.
There you go. There you go. There's the true essence of her right there.
I'm
going to
go hack with a green piece joke.
You're not going to be able to find a picture of Scarlett Johansson with a brick sticking out of her face, you're going to be able to find it if you want to find an ugly picture of her.
Why are you getting mad?
Ugly
I'm not getting mad. I'm telling you that.
That's not hot. Look at that.
Look at my saggy tits on vacation.
Damn.
She was sick in that picture.
What is that, Tank Williams?
She was sick in that
it's like Tank Williams on vacation.
Can you take the time to find some bad Scarlett Johansson pictures?
Please? It's almost impossible
another
at this point in her life.
Another fucking disaster is the one that does the live from the Apollo and was in Precious. What's her name?
Precious.
Monique,
don't fucking tell me Monique.
Monique
struts out on that stage.
They're not
like,
the same category.
Uh huh. Look at my dress, honey. Look at my. And everybody goes.
And she doesn't shave her legs.
And she's disgusting.
That's the type of political correctness we have to end before we're going to get anywhere in this nation.
Pick an ugly Scarlett Johansson pick. Come on, which one you want, Patrice?
That's not Scarlett Johansson.
That's Lindsay Lohan.
On fucking meth.
She's a piece of ass, period.
Oh, Scarlett Johansson.
See, they don't put a, there you
no,
go.
No, you ain't gonna find one.
Where'd you go?
I'm
where'd you go?
You ain't gonna
right
find
here.
One.
There you go. There you go.
Click that one.
There you go.
All right, let's go.
I don't even think she's that
come
high.
On. Let's go. Come on.
I love Scarlett Johansson.
Come on.
Oh, now it's not working. Danny got an emergency text now to show the ugly fucking
loading with
fucking. You got 20,000 old.
It's the white man working against you. We're not going to load that bad picture for the black man.
60. Emergency text.
Oh, it was loaded.
Every girl we've talked about in the last 10 minutes, Derek Jeter has fucked twice.
There you go. Thank you.
That's not good.
Still fucker.
I'm still fucker. Wait a minute. Can you just admit, though?
That's everyone what? Takes that's a bad photo.
Yeah, that's a bad picture.
Well,
that
why
is
didn't someone say that when Latifah?
Because Latifah had 5,000 bad photos.
She's ugly.
She took one.
It's the other way around with Latifah. Right. She's always ugly, and they gussy her up for movies.
That's right.
That's right.
And wait a minute. Does that picture of Scarlett Johansson not prove?
Danny, show the sweater picture.
Wait a minute, though, but does that not prove the same
thing? Is that ugly, Patrice?
Is that... Of what?
Oh, my God.
Look at that.
Holy wait a minute. Holy. I'd look good in that outfit. For
could you put it on there?
I'll
Anthony,
say you would.
The fact that we just seen that photo of Scarlett Johansson, isn't that the same fact for her, too? Is that she's that?
No,
and you have to put makeup on to make her this?
We had to search out one, and it took forever.
It was her in a
find another one.
Yeah, it was her in a Ralph's parking lot carrying tampons in a hat.
Yeah, because she fucking stays in the house. Latifah goes out.
She didn't have tits like
she goes to Red Lobster
out on the highway.
I think Latifah's pretty.
Come on. Latifah's pretty.
She's not pretty.
Not pretty.
But you don't think any black women are pretty? You
I showed
said
you
Vivian Fox.
For the Zillow video.
Wait, you said Vivian Fox. Vivica, actually. It's you said Vivian. Vivica. Show him Vivica
I said
Fox.
Jada Pinkett.
Oh, show
it is
him,
Vivica. You're right.
Show him
you're
Vivica.
Right. I'll give you another nice black woman. You're Vanessa Williams.
Yeah, in her day, yes.
In her day,
maybe.
She was pretty delicious.
Is this
like Vivica?
And I like the maid from the Jeffersons.
I never liked Vivica that much.
Why? Florence Henderson was lovely.
Because she's black.
No, because she's ugly.
No, Florence.
She's not ugly.
Yeah. Oh.
I like Jada Pinkett Smith.
Because she's a baby, has a baby body, and she's light.
It's a bad Vivica Fox.
What, do I need a certain tone for them to be black?
Yes, yeah, motor oil. You don't like black women.
You got to look like motor oil, according to Patrice.
No. You don't like black women in general.
No,
so you don't see the fact that I can see Adrian Barbeau.
I don't either, though. I don't get turned on by black women.
The fact that I can look at Adrian Barbeau.
Nothing for me.
Yeah.
And not on a race.
And see something in Adrian Barbeau means that I have a fair eye. You can't see Latifah and go,
see, you're racist again, Anthony.
No, because she's fat and ugly.
Ugly woman.
Yeah, she is.
You're using the wrong woman to prove your point. That Latifah is a rough one, man.
Hey, Danny.
Do me a favor.
I think that's rough for most black guys, too.
Bring up Takara. T-O-C-A-R-A.
Danny's head is going to
make the same argument with a better-looking girl.
Takara.
Takara.
All right, let's go with Takara.
All right. Click.
Find a black girl that is hot.
Can we
looks Asian.
Jesus.
Better than Latifah, but
That's what I'm saying. See, this is an unfair argument because there's nobody.
No, I'm not trying.
This is the same
that's
kind
better.
Of chick.
She looked like Lena Horne.
Is Lena Horne ugly?
No.
No, I didn't find Lena Horne attractive.
He said, do you hear this piece of shit? He said, please bring up Lena Horne.
I didn't find Lena Horne attractive.
This will prove I saw her on.
I'd rather fuck Mother Jefferson.
Really?
I'm sorry.
She was pretty lady.
She's all right.
I didn't
let
find
me see
Lena Horne.
There weren't as many sexy photos because it was old school. Let me see a picture of her.
Exactly.
Look at that.
Pictures
look
back then, she's
look at that one. Fucking picture, man.
Look. That is a good picture of Lena Horne.
Yeah, it is.
Right there.
Yeah, there you go.
And I give her a smooth.
As racy as they got back then.
Show her what she looks
like.
Like
cleaning her oven.
Well, she looks dead today.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Yeah, Lena Hall.
I didn't know that. I meant that picture late in her
life.
With the gray
hair.
When she's 97?
Oh, my God.
She's still sexier
she's all right.
than Bea Arthur ever was.
Bea Arthur is a hot baby.
White women get haggard. White women get haggard after 32.
First of all, that's a white man, Bea Arthur.
White women start melting after 29.
Bea Arthur is gay.
Let's be honest.
Bea Arthur is gay. A pair of gay woman.
Lena Horne was very pretty.
Hey, Nick's going to be at Foxwoods?
My favorite girl was Honka.
Nick DiPaolo, Foxwoods, tonight, tomorrow, and Saturday, filming the DVD on Saturday night. Nick DiPaolo at Foxwoods. You got to go and check out Nick.
800-200-2882 for tickets. I go to nick.com and click on something there that my web guy put up. I'm sure it'll take you right there.
All right, good. And
I don't know.
And Patrice is at Bananas this weekend.
I'll be doing my
Friday. Let's not make a joke about.
Where are you taping?
At this place over in what's
what is this
place?
About, Patrice?
Yeah, I'm taping my Comedy
Central
special.
Fucking know that?
Well, I was trying to get it out. If Nick shut the fuck up for a second. About his racism. If he stopped being racist for 5 seconds.
Why are you doing that now? I've been nice to you. Nothing but nice to you the whole time. I even pretended I like black women for this segment.
Well, Patrice, it's November 5th, so you come back when it gets a little closer to really pop.
But where is it?
It's at that Skirball Center.
I've been here in the Village.
The NYU place.
Yeah, it's fucking great.
I've been there for a million of you guys' tapings over the years. Comedy Central taping for Patrice.
I taped the HBO thing there. It's fucking. It's right on the corner of... it's by Washington Square Park.
Yeah, it's
fucking
right there.
Great theater. Saga tape.
It really is nice. Theblacklistnyc.com for tickets. Big Mama Proz on Twitter. Are you guys going to be all right after this show?
Yeah. Go see Nick. He's taping his
We did that.
He really?
Yeah.
How many cameras, Nick?
Three.
Three
you
cameras.
To get your cab after the show?
Oh, motherfucker.
I just was seeing how many cameras it was. I was just making sure it wasn't more than my
I did one at the Wilbur Theater. I did one at the Wilbur Theater, too. So, it hasn't been released yet. So, but
why not?
Because I'm holding it. They're afraid of me. I say shit.
Nick's
on stage like I do to Patrice.
Something happened
and,
to Nick. You're
the
right,
people
Patrice.
That run Comedy Central something just can't fucking handle that.
Something happened to him back, yeah.
A little bit.
Because his first album was...
I had three half hours. That was the problem. I burned more material than all of you.
I still feel the same as the last one. Starring Nick. That's Nick DiPaolo. I still feel the same. That's a good fucking name.
No, it's called... it's something about... Yeah. It's,
what's the name of it?
I don't know yet. It's going to be called...
Let me name it for you.
Jigaboo Coon Hats.
What kind of... You guys are implying I'm racist.
I know.
When it's white honesty is
realist.
What I bring to the stage.
Yeah,
you know?
I'm racist. I'm a realist.
It's called, here, white bum, here's a quarter. Hey, nigger bum, die and eat my balls, you piece of shit, motherfucker.
That's a long title for a CD.
Yes. It's a two-disc.
No room for a picture on the front of that CD.
Wait, here it is. Obama Oshmama. That's
That's going to be called The Great Uniter.
Yes.
That's not a bad name.
Oh, damn, that's great. Obi and Anthony, with a virus. Serious accent.